There we go.
The freestyle by Corey Holcomb and this bitch. Cause I don't like your daughter, bitch. I don't like your daughter, bitch. Ever since I saw the little hoe, niggas knocking on my motherfucking door.
Is Trina there? Is she coming out?
I say, hey, put that thing in that bitch's mouth. Cause I don't like your daughter, bitch. Going in my refrigerator. Every nigga that nut in her, somehow they hate her.
Ow.
Her two kids that she kept cause she thought them dudes was gonna give her fuck. But then they ducked out on her ass. Fuck that silly slut. Even though that bitch do got a big ass butt. But I won't fuck her though. Cause it's your daughter. But get the daughter out my face before the slaughter. I don't like your daughter, bitch.
Oh, I told you he had some shit.
I didn't get a chance to check the camera and see how that looked.
You couldn't tell how you look?
No. I don't know if my hair is extra frizzy. Because I just washed my hair when
I wash
my hair.
Look for real. I'm going to be honest with you.
No, it gets real frizzy. My hair, I have to put some of this stuff in.
That means you don't want to hear it. What up, y'all? 5150.
Is it really messed up?
What? I was finished saying. You said something okay, go like ahead. I didn't even say the question.
I'm sorry. Go ahead.
What?
What happened?
No, you want to know how you look today?
Yeah. Uh-oh.
What?
Got boogie.
Anybody else want to say it? No, you ain't got
what,
a boogie.
What,
so? She look good to me.
Well,
she
look right. Good to
you.
Yeah. Bastard. My hair
so, is... Your ass always got some nice shit to say.
She does look good to me.
Damn.
No.
You look good today. Come on,
yeah.
Bro. It's okay, man.
She don't look
no,
good today?
I'm
you
not,
know that's game, man. That's,
I'm
that's
not saying that.
Game. But... Hey, you look sick today.
Anyway, no, I couldn't I see the... Sick. Oh, hey. Oh, we're on. Sorry about that.
You tell us what you think she looks like today.
She looks housekeepish today.
Uh-oh.
What is housekeeping?
Housekeeping.
Like
a real, real nice housekeeper.
God.
Don't worry, I come back.
Right.
All right. All right, retired football coach. All right.
Retired
football coach. Who's that for me? I guess.
All right,
everybody huddle up.
Anyway. Hey, what's up?
What's up,
oh,
y'all?
Oh, my God.
What up?
A lot of shit out there in the news.
Man. Oh, shit.
I got to say this shit.
What you about to talk about? See, you let us know.
I don't give a fuck. If you got it on your shit, then I got to say this.
All right.
Because I've been holding it in.
Uh-oh.
Everybody has something to say about KD going to go.
Oh, thank God you're talking about that, because I don't have none of that. That is not appealing to me. Go ahead.
Listen. Listen to me.
I'm going to be honest. Hold on. Before I say this, I'm
go ahead. Keep it 100.
When I heard that, I was like, I couldn't wait to hear what you had to say.
Let's see.
I already knew.
Now we're about
to. I already knew something was coming down the pike. Here we go.
Look, man. I didn't want KD to go to Golden State.
No. That's going to be a problem.
I didn't want him to go. I wanted him to beat Golden State.
Yeah.
Because of my... thing I have with little spoiled ass Steph Curry. Because, like, I feel like he's spoiled and privileged and all like that. You know what I'm saying? That's just me. I don't hate the kid. I think he's the best shooter in the history of the NBA, but...
So he should be a little spoiled and privileged then.
Nah, but I'm saying, like, that little...
Right.
the little suburban kid type thing he got going on.
Hey, man, not everybody
I'm a city guy.
From the hood. Everybody can't be from the city, man.
Yeah.
I get
you
it,
gotta
man.
Have somebody to sell the shit to, man.
I get Jeez. That. I Jeez. Understand what you're saying.
Sheesh.
If it wasn't for dope fiends, it would have been slow. DM
from the burbs, where can I score?
But the little suburban kids, you know, they always kind of got up under my skin because I was a city guy. You know what I mean? I was like, we had to go get it.
New shoes and shit.
Right.
Here I am in a fucking hovel.
Right. My shoes come from the grocery store.
Oh, right.
And my brother
they
got
a little rubber.
I got them when my brother got done.
The All Star.
The all-star looking.
We used to call them meatheads.
What?
We used to call them meatheads. Meathead? That big, thick. That was when the rubber up front was real.
Right. We call them Bobos.
Bobos?
Bobos.
We called them or bins. Buddies. Bins. Out bins. Of the bins.
Buddies. I heard of buddies. Out of the
bins. I heard buddies.
Sneaking on some buddies.
Got on some Bobos. Like the slip. I remember when the slip-on Vans was popular. Aww. Cats would come with the thin rubber sole instead of the
karate
thick.
Shoe, damn man.
Well, karate but shoes just white so happen to be shoe. Cool.
That's true.
But them shits was cheap to the
don't
motherfucker.
Let a when nail
you, when you stopping them karate shoes one time, your big toe was like, oh, so this is what the world look like.
Yo. And what about the nigga, what about the nigga that could run fast
wait,
in them that always
karate
wanted
shoes?
To race?
Yeah.
Corey, did you ever
nigga.
Wear
that nigga.
You wore some?
Shits were slapping.
I thought that was a total West Coast thing.
No, my mama bought us some karate shoes. Hell we yeah. Was shouting. They was cheap. They sold them at the grocery store.
$5. Yep.
Different colors.
Right five next to the bucks. Puff Rice cereal.
Oh. On the Big Bang.
The big should take bang. The milk. 20 minutes to make that shit soft.
Yeah, put it up on the counter. Let the light get to it.
Right.
Anyway, so what was your end take on
but
it?
Yo, I'm just saying, for KD, I'm happy for him. I really hope that he wins some championships because I want him to win a championship.
And that's the old
because how old is he now?
Join him.
How old is he?
It is the game beat him. It's the game beat him. Join him.
Is it still?
Can't beat him.
But he put in a lot of time in OKC.
9 years.
Put in a lot of time. It's time to go to a market where you can
blow up.
Yeah, you can blow up. You know what I'm saying? A lot of great players do it.
Hey, he could always go back to Oklahoma years from now as a champion.
Yeah.
You may do him that solid. Right. You know, look at LeBron. Right.
And plus, he just has one of those faces. Like, oh, he'd be mad at him.
Kevin Durant?
Yeah, he's got. He does. I'm going to look at him.
Also,
I hope you know that same face will get him stolen. On
I know
head.
That. That's what I'm saying. But that's so what I'm saying.
You go, yeah. Run that nigga's pockets.
When you get up on Kevin Durant, that's when you realize, oh, this motherfucker's 6'10". This ain't no
6'11".
This is a big motherfucker
God
right
dang.
Here.
But they say he's 27 in there, though.
Is he? Oh, and he's sweet. Look, he's young. Looks like he's really sweet.
Yeah. You know,
get that money, player.
I'm rooting for you, G. You know what I'm saying? That's
Joe
what I
money.
And that, Stephen A.
Your knee could be blown out next year, man.
Stephen
get the
A.
money.
Smith had the nerve to say something bad about him.
Wait, they said Steph Curry's
you know,
older
it's
than
like,
is
yo,
he old?
Man, you talk, you know, I watched him when he was on with the little sissy. Because, you know, the sissy left for more money, too. The sissy left for Fox.
Skip Bayless is
oh, yeah,
Skip
Bayless.
To.
My bad. Sissy Bayless.
Skipping
you know, stop.
But he appraised his move, Stephen A. Smith. Oh, congratulations. Woo, woo, woo. But he is a brother. Mm. He talks shit about brothers. So that's why I was glad.
You was in the big house.
He said, you did it.
You gave up your pillar?
Right.
Pillar? You gave up your pillar to go sleep in what you think is a bigger house?
Anyway, Stephen A. Smith, I just want to tell you, man, I hope people really play this little clip right here.
You got it?
Stephen A. Smith. No, I'm talking about like to Stephen A. Smith. I hope they play it to Stephen A. Smith.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
You a fucking coward. You talk shit. And one of these days, when you out here, all them people, all them black people you talk shit about, gonna run up on you one day. I know it's gonna happen. Mm. So all that shit you say about black people, Tom Brady, all that shit, never said nothing negative about him. Never. Mm-hmm. He words it in a slick way about Tom Brady. And everybody else, that's not black. But if you are black, he flat out talks shit about you.
Right. So can we ask the question then? Was it weak of LeBron to leave Cleveland when he left Cleveland to go to Miami the first time?
This is what I want to say to a lot of people who may be against what LeBron did or what Kevin Durant did. Listen, I'm a Bulls fan back when Jordan was playing. Jordan wasn't even the highest paid player in the NBA.
That's true.
And every stadium he went to, it was sold out like some rock star shit.
Because of him.
he fucking made the NBA so much
billions.
Money.
Yeah. Yeah.
So listen to what I'm saying to all them people who think the players are fucking up. Fuck that. When it really come down to it, get your money and be in a tranquil situation.
Yep.
Running with niggas who can hoop.
That's what I say.
I get the whole, oh, I'm going to win it on my own. But fuck that when it really boils down to it.
Because the league ain't like that now anyway. Exactly. You trying to make these guys hold them to a standard to a league that ain't even the same. This ain't the Magic Jordan Bird era no more.
This ain't the Kareem era. This ain't when ballin' was ballin'. This has been about money.
Right.
This is a money league. So get your money. Right. Don't be out here like, well, I'm gonna stay till the Gipper gets out the hospital. Right. Hey man, listen. I say it's not weak. That's why I say it's not a weak move, because everybody wants you to do one thing.
I mean, most of these guys,
but you gotta take
homies.
A strong stand to do what you want to do with your career.
Mm-hmm. Right. Most of these guys are friends. Most of these guys played since high school. Came across each other in high school. Played on travel ball teams. They grew up together, basically. So these guys don't have a problem playing with each other, playing against each other. Mm-hmm. They don't have a problem. I mean, they even thinking that Wade might rejoin LeBron in Cleveland.
Hmm.
Whatever these players do, I'm saying for people who are realistic, you can't be talking crazy to these players about them motherfuckers doing what they want
to
do for
their
piece
of mind. Look what happened to LeBron. Right. That was
their money and be happy with it.
Where did all those people go? Where did those people go?
LeBron James has never done nothing to deserve the scrutiny he got.
What happened, yeah.
Because he wanted to play in Miami.
That was terrible what they were doing.
A kid.
Burning that shit. Remember that?
Look, man, these dudes is kids, man.
When he was in high school, Freeze, do you know they took games away from him? Because a store owner gave him a couple of jerseys. They've been fucking him for years, man.
Right.
And motherfuckers talk shit about LeBron. LeBron is a motherfucking family man. I know KD and how close he is as far as it go with family ties and shit. I mean, it's my white cousin.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I'm just keeping it real. So, of course, I want the best for him. When it really boiled down to it, fuck these teams. Mm-hmm. When it really boiled down to it, when it's time to chop it up.
That's what I'm saying.
Man, look,
get your bread, man. It's entertainment, man.
Mm-hmm.
It's entertainment.
It's WWE.
It's real.
They call fouls how they want to call fouls.
When they want to call fouls, then call the fouls differently the next game. Or maybe not even the next game, the next quarter. You don't know what the fuck you're going to get.
It's entertainment.
Yeah. There you go. Probably a big computer readout that the refs got to memorize the calls. Here you go, Miller. Here you go, Dwight. Here you go, Riverside.
Riverside.
I got a foul in the fourth period. It says that. That's what you got to do. All right.
I got to say this. That one kid from Memphis.
Oh, Conley.
He has had nothing but good shit since he been in the NBA.
$153 million contract. The largest contract in NBA history.
Mm. And you're not even the type of player that could take your team to the finals.
How did he get that? What did he do to get that?
He's solid. That motherfucker's solid. Where he came from. He's
the fuck out of here.
He's not a solid game manager.
Well, so why do you think he got that?
There's only way he can be the highest paid player in the NBA with his skill set. He is fucking somebody.
Oh, my Lord.
I don't know who he is fucking.
He loaded the belt. Bow.
But he fucking somebody. Phil Jackson was fucking the Lakers' owner daughter, so it got him a lot of shit.
Oh, my Lord.
Am I right, though? Phil Jackson was fucking the Lakers' owner daughter?
I don't put it past
him. But a player?
Yeah. This is real life.
That's still his woman.
Fucking somebody.
It goes down.
A lot of hookups I get. That came from motherfucking some real shit. Yeah. Like, I remember when I used to have a hookup at the DMV. That was the shit.
Yep.
Fuck.
So did we,
I had to fuck that bitch butt. I ain't never waited in line.
Wait, what happened?
Hold on.
You had to do what?
I fucked a fat bitch to avoid the lines. I don't even got to call in for the appointment. I just walk in. As soon as we make eye contact, I get walked right up.
Are you serious?
That's right. It's called.
We had the hookup, but we didn't have to sleep with anybody.
Dick sacrifice. Yeah,
I was just about to say, yo, I had that hookup too. I just was like.
Hey.
Oh, are you talking about you got the hookup based off if you see somebody you know?
No.
I talk just about every time you go in there.
Every time.
And if they know
they're,
you.
They're retired now. They play yeah. out.
So you ain't got that hookup no more?
Nah.
My fat bitch still left.
Well. Fuck her right in the pussy.
Oh, Chris. God. Okay, let's move on.
Corey, it's time for that registration, baby.
Get her back up. Back up. Let him to the front of the line.
I ain't have to fuck her but once. She got a husband now. But she still hooked me up
for
that one home run night.
She said, this one here, he can move it and groove it. Let him to the front of the line.
She a fat bitch with little feet, too, so it wasn't that bad. The fat bitches with the big feet, that's what throw me off. They be like, what's wrong with your dick? Bitch, what's wrong with your feet?
Lord. When they got little feet, they like a spinning top.
Right.
Stop.
Little sausage foot with toenail polish on it. That's better than that big ass platypus bill some of these big bitches be having.
Slappers. Slapping around in the shower.
Hold my leg up. Bitch, hold your leg down. Let that leg come above my motherfucking neck. I don't want to see that foot.
Take this.
Corey has a problem with big, ashy, fat feet.
Everybody does, right?
And that ain't just it. There's a
big, ashy. You see,
there's
first
a
off,
compilement. There's a whole feet. List of what you don't like.
I think
Corey.
I'm looking at my own feet.
He says a whole list of what I don't like. I bet. What can you name? What?
Noses, chins.
You do have a problem with chins.
Certain
for sure.
Makeup, every clothes,
time a girl in
there, shoes.
You find something wrong with her
shoes,
chin.
A handbag.
What are you talking about? Y'all just reaching. I don't.
No.
I'm not a chin judger.
Yes,
a chin judger.
No, it's not just chins. It's just a lot of things. You nitpick little.
Everybody has unique shit about them, and if I talk shit about it, that's my shit. I'm talking about it, but. It's people who talk shit about me.
I know, but I'm just saying you specifically, you zone in on
this girl told me, why don't you shave your pubic hair? I said, because I'm grown.
Well.
I'm not shaving my pubic hair to make you happy.
Right, running around looking like a toddler.
Right.
So you can be cool.
An oversized
big-ass toddler.
Yeah, you call that they call that the dolphin. The dolphin.
Man, you got no. I agree.
Be like, come look at this pelvic, bitch.
What?
When
you ain't got no pubic hair, your pelvic is exposed.
Exposed.
Come look at this pelvic, bitch.
You get a pelvic cold.
What?
You get chest colds because ain't no hair on it.
Oh,
man,
Lord.
With chest hair, don't never get chest cold.
Oh,
damn.
Shit.
You get a pelvic cold if you shave all your pubic hair and shit. All them porno niggas be at the doctor. The doctor be like, oh, that's a pelvic cold. Don't worry about it.
You put on, all right.
Put on some wool drawers.
Some wool drawers.
Some wool drawers.
Some wool.
Mm. Maybe you need weave on your dick.
Mm-mm.
Damn.
That's terrible.
Yeah, that's some silly shit to me.
Anyway. All right.
So we're going to get D shit out the way.
Oh, geez. Thank you so much.
It's that time.
Now that I finished my maid work, sir.
We got to stomach this segment.
Now that I've cleaned all the rooms. All right.
Oh, come back tomorrow.
Uh-oh. the do not disturb sign was up. I didn't see it. Okay, here we go.
We got to say the topic, though. We got to say.
That's right. Bring me in officially. You? Okay, all right.
She must got some good shit. She ready to get that shit out.
No.
Let's say it fast, y'all.
Loose talk about bullshit.
Oh, geez. Thank you, guys. God, Jesus. All right. Well, as you know, it was the 4th of July weekend. Fireworks, okay. Come
oh my
to.
God, that was crazy last
it,
night.
Everywhere. I think
turn
for some reason, everywhere.
Right. Broadway, it was crazy.
You everywhere.
Know, I went to Long Beach, drove back on the 110 the whole
way.
That's what I was just going to say.
Just,
if you was like the freeway, if you was on the 405. Or the 105 or whatever, them rolls up for
yeah.
You see the shit, you're like,
all
is
over.
Everybody popping fireworks?
Yeah.
This shit look
yeah.
like, this shit look crazy.
Well,
and yo, you know what I say? For every place you see fireworks, pretty much guaranteed that those same people got heat.
Yeah, same pretty much. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So anyway, speaking of fireworks, excessive fireworks, fireworks in general. Anyway, obviously, Nick Young of the Lakers didn't pay attention to what happened to Jason Pierre-Paul last year. After, remember we spoke about this last year, about Jason Pierre-Paul's accident when he blew off his hand?
Yeah.
Okay, I got pictures. That's how it looks now. Oh. That's how it looks now. But damn, the ones that you can look online, horrific.
What's
don't,
that one? Over, what?
They had to graft. They had to make another finger out of another of meat.
Make a hand look like plantain.
You know what? Jesus Christ, I'm sorry about that, Jason.
Okay, that's right. We're going to cut those up. We want the pantacón, mira.
Stop.
Mira, we got the pantacón.
Plantain. I'm not laughing at Jason. I'm so sorry.
They're going to eat his fingers.
Stop
oh,
it.
Oh, papi, that's okay. Your hand. I thought, oh, stop. My goodness.
Fuck. Okay, anyway, that's damn. That is Jason Pierre-Paul. It
what
happened.
Happened?
It happened, happened last year, all right? Last year?
Chocolate
okay, what happened
nuggets.
Was he was throwing, he throws like an annual party at his house, right?
Okay.
Really big party. And if you look up the story, because I don't have the, all the details of that, because I was going to go more into what happened to, almost happened to Nick Young. Anyway, they were almost out of the fireworks, and he had a couple of $1,000 worth of fireworks. I mean, it's like a big annual thing he does. And there was like one that didn't want to go off, and he walked over to it, and he picked it up. And when he picked it up,
he's
everybody just saw
guy.
It. Yes. Yeah. So anyway, so let's keep going.
Swaggy P.
So Nick Young.
What did he do?
Okay, so during his annual, now he started a firework thing. Now, if you go online, you can actually see the video.
That nigga blew his curl back.
No, it looks like the it looks like it did though. So he, what an idiot though. He goes and he picks up. It's a lit firework. It's on the ground and it wasn't doing it. And he goes and he picks it up and he holds it and everybody's like, "Nah!" You just hear all these yells and screams and all of a sudden it just shoot. And he's like, "Oh goddamn!" I mean, it really looks worse than it is. He did not get hurt. Thank
I was
about God.
To say, I saw this dude today.
But no, but I'm saying,
no
can you imagine
the
that?
Shot was off now. Now so I go, understand why the shot was off.
Go online
Swaggy
and
pop,
you can
God
see
damn
it. Yeah. So go online no, and you man. Can see that. But anyway, back to Jason Paul. Last year that happened. If that's how fresh it is. Anyway, he.
His hand looked like a bitch pussy.
God.
I'll fuck the shit out your finger, nigga.
Anyway, listen, he has been off deck the whole time ever since, but he did get back into his workout regimen, and he got back. He's signed. They kept him, but his contract is way lower, way different. But he just released. He's been off deck because I guess he was embarrassed or whatever. And he just released a PSA speaking about the safety of fireworks. So that's his way of finally coming out, speaking about it. So he just released the PSA this
weekend.
His
fingers are gone and he's still playing?
Oh, yeah. Did you see the
but
show the
you
other
don't
picture,
know
Chris?
About this dude. This
he's
dude
a beast.
Is
he's
literally
a beast.
About
thank you.
6'5".
Yeah.
But move quick, strong. He was a mutant.
There he is. Yeah, but the No. I gave you
that's iced tea.
Shut up. God, I wish. Oh, Jesus Christ. Whew. Oh, dang it. I thought I sent you the other picture. Anyway, there's pictures of him playing because now the New York
yeah,
Giants
they
have signed
like
him.
A glove.
They have a glove. And
that's who he's been with. The
and
the
Under
Giants.
Armour has reconfigured the glove for him. But he plays. He actually plays. And I thought I sent you a picture of him sacking this guy. Anyway, he's still sacking people. He's like
clawing.
Incredible.
Now he's the claw.
I know it's hard to rape a bitch when your hand like that. Bitch, keep getting away. Goddamn.
It's hard to get numbers. Hold on, let me. Damn it.
Oh, damn it.
You type it in.
Any little pieces of shit don't dial.
Damn it.
I just hit too many numbers at once.
I'm going to need you to
you
do
guys
it.
Are so awful.
He got to have a shoehorn. He can't get no tight shoes on with that hand. Right
oh, shit, damn
look
it.
Put my shoehorn. I ain't about to.
Put your number in now.
Anyway, God, you guys are be laughing. It's so horrible.
I mean, shoehorn got one of them things just go around the wrist. So he just got to.
That nigga can't clean his ass, Twizzler, right?
Well, wait. Now, they've made a special. They've made special adaptations for him. Like
special washcloths.
And they actually made one for him to work out because he actually lost 30 pounds when he was in the hospital. He came out and he is 30 pounds lighter.
I know them little fingers he got left is strong than a mother.
But if you look all this stuff online, it's very fascinating.
With them.
It's fascinating, the stuff that he works
with. It smells like charcoal. his fingers.
But no, honestly, seriously, those were the decent photos that I found of the exposed hand. If you go online, oh my God, poor Jason. Oh,
everybody knows you're supposed to get a fucking stick and hit the fucking
He went and picked that sucker up, dumbass. And it was a malfunction. It was badly made. Anyway, he's back to normal now. And like I said, he released his PSA.
Art Vardhan.
God damn it,
Nugget.
Stop it.
Play for the Nuggets.
They called him Nugget Knuckles.
No, God dang it.
God damn it.
Anyway, he says that he says that he's happy. He doesn't want to dwell on it.
Yeah, CeeLo Green hand.
Shit, damn it.
Damn.
Anyway, he says that he's happy. And that, of course, he wishes he could be back to normal, but he doesn't want to dwell on it. And he thanks the Lord because it could have been much worse.
Yeah.
He signed another year, 1 year. And what is this? It says he signed another 1 year, a show me deal. So I guess every year.
Show me.
It's called a show me deal.
Show me how many fingers.
No, that's what the deal's called. It's got left, they said he signed another year, a show me deal year with the New York Giants. It's payable up to $10.5 million, but right now he's guaranteed $4 million.
Well, he was a monster before.
He's still playing, so we wish Jason the best.
And we do, man. I don't want no.
Of course,
we
wish that brother the best. Goddamn it, but that nigga got to scratch his ass with effort.
I bet you right now that motherfucker just opened a beer with that fucked up hand. He said, "Yeah, but it's good for this nigga." Pop.
He can't get that finger under no beer top.
Oh, probably just poke it in there hard, right. Mother. Like, pop. And going just, in.
But I highly recommend that you don't.
Steel straws for his beer. He'd be like, "Blood."
Don't look it up. Don't look the photos up, even though you're going to. But don't look the photos up because they do have it when he very first came in the hospital.
Wow,
man. Looks like he was in that club in Orlando.
God. Okay, let's. Too soon.
What?
Hey, Chris.
God, Jesus.
That new sound you got?
Oh, what? Shit.
With the bitch singing? You ready?
Right now?
You ready?
Yeah.
When that firecracker went off in his hand, he was like.
Dang it, Mariah. Leave her alone.
Oh, no. He was like, what?
Wait, one more time?
He was like.
Oh, Jesus Christ, Jason. I didn't choose to go there.
Damn.
Oh, shit.
Oh, that nigga was shaking his hand like a motherfucker.
Oh, no, he wrapped his shirt all around. Yeah, the whole story, actually,
yeah,
Sports Illustrated.
Piss on that finger to get that motherfucker up from burning.
Sports Illustrated just released a current interview with him where they give every detail. It's a really good story about. What happened?
I was about 10 feet away, and I thought I noticed a spark. Now, my first instinct was to stay where
detail.
I was, but
Chris,
I decided to walk
look
in.
Look up the body issue for ESPN, the magazine. Old boy Woodfork, who used to play for the New England Patriots. That's all you got to do.
What does that mean?
Who is this?
Man, this nigga... Pose nude for ESPN the magazine.
Oh, bogus, God. Does he look good?
We going to show him.
All right.
Go ahead, D. What else you got?
I'll be able to tell you. All right, your boy. Oh, your boy Shaq. Anyway, Shaq, who is usually against his children being in any kind of reality show because he's been against it with Shawnee bringing him on. Smart. However, they have a new show. It is for VH1, and they're filming it now, along with his entire family, including ex-wife Shawnee, all their children, including one of hers from a previous relationship. It'll focus on the kids, how they're working their careers in to their lives, and also one kid wants to be a comedian, another one wants to be in music, and then their 17-year-old Sharif O'Neal, who's a top high school basketball player that's currently being recruited by some of the best colleges in the country, and they say that they will actually follow that process on the show. And on one of the first episodes, they show the... a huge, like, celebrity-attended big party that they put on for Shaq's 13-year-old boy named Shakur. Anyway, Shaq said, it'll be like the Kardashians, but in a good way. Oh, you got the picture of the family, or you already popped it up that quick? Anyway, so they put a picture up on VH1 red carpet of them for the show.
That's Shaq family?
That's for the show, yeah.
That's Shaq's son?
That's their kids.
Mm-hmm. Damn, boy, them kids done grew the fuck up.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Where's the old girl he was married to?
That's her right there in the middle, Shawnee.
That's her?
Yeah, with the tore jeans on the knee.
Oh, she got that hair in.
Yeah.
Look at Shaq. He look at how he's standing. He's like, I ain't with that bitch.
He way over on the other side, huh?
I'm here with my son.
I'm here for my son.
And my kids.
Oh, God.
And I said go.
I fell on ESP on TNT.
I don't care. My kids,
hey,
I say
hey,
go.
Hey, Shaq, I don't know if you watching this, nigga. I'm glad you all right. But when you fell, tripped over that cord.
Oh, really? Are you serious? It was a bat.
Who put that in?
That was the funniest. And then he blamed, oh boy, the white dude, Ernie.
What? Yeah. I got to
like,
see
you
that.
You got me, Ernie. I'm like, what he do, my friend? You tripped, nigga.
He was supposed to trip first.
Oh. Nigga, that shit was so funny, nigga. You know what's
We might have to look that one up. Oh, yeah, my once God. He's I'm going to look that up on the break.
They have a beautiful family.
They do. They do.
Right.
Yeah, they do.
I blessed him. That's right. I hope they. I wish him the best, man.
So is that Shaq's daughter right there?
Daughters.
With the new that's Shaq's daughter? Evan?
I don't think her kid, or either that or that's her daughter, but I know that they have four or
that
five.
That one girl,
that's
Shaq's daughter right there with the jeans and the jacket.
Hunching over? Because she looked just like the mom.
No, did she look like Shaq?
You think so? I think she looks like Shawnee. Look, they got the same chin, head shape.
Chin. She got Shawnee chin and Shaq head. Look at the top.
I can't. Jesus Christ.
No, what? It's his daughter. That ain't me joking.
We don't know.
Well, I don't know.
Everything come out your mouth is silly.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Anyway, yeah,
is
that's
that
their
daughter
kids.
With the Nuvia, New York?
I don't know because they have five. All that's all their kids, and I don't think her kid from the previous relationship is in that photo. But
so and if it was, that would
they're going to
be
in the show,
too.
Though.
So the other kid ain't in the photo? What, is he grown now or something?
I think so,
oh,
yeah.
Good. He like, I ain't fucking with you.
Oh, you don't know. They said he's going to be on the show, or he or she.
Right. He might have been late. He'd be like,
whoever
look.
That other kid is sympathy.
Oh, stop it
you
all
ain't
the heck.
Shit right now.
That's his mom.
What?
Or her mom. Is it a boy?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
I don't know if it's a girl or a boy, but if you're not Shaq's seed, you are pity.
Yeah.
Are you for real?
Well, that's the truth. You know it's pity. Speak to the girl, kid that was there when you got there out of obligation. You know, you hey, what's up, boy? You good? So how you straight? All right, cool. Yeah, fuck what happened to this little motherfucker.
Oh boy. See, that's why I never got
mama,
with no.
Right, little nigga?
See, that's why I never got with anybody when my kid was young.
Open up that goddamn window.
Give me that damn milk.
Hang that nigga out like.
Oh, stop.
You want to look at my books?
Anyway, so that's coming soon on VH1. Also, speaking of freak accidents, okay, because we did speak on a freak accident before this.
What is a freak
story?
Accident? When
I'm about to bring one up for you, sucker. The previous accident was the homeboy's hand and Nick almost blowing his hand. Anyway, this one.
That was a freak accident.
That was horrific.
That was a freak accident. Freak accident is you walk down the street and the fucking horse falls on you.
Well, no. This is a freak.
That's a freak accident.
No, this is a freak accident. Here we go.
Picking up a motherfucking firecracker.
All right, you're right.
Destiny.
Yeah, you're right. He was in control of that kind of accident. So anyway, last Tuesday, ex-NFLer, and that was the picture I gave you, Chris, of that good-looking fella. Bless his heart. Anyway, last Tuesday, ex-NFLer Zerlon Tipton was accidentally shot by his own gun. He was in Detroit, there to attend his daughter's kindergarten graduation.
Hold on, the nigga name, what?
Zerlon Tipton.
Zerlon? What was the other nigga that shit himself? He had a fucking, what's his name?
Plexico.
Zerlon. These niggas is aliens, man. Yeah. They don't know how guns work.
Oh, my God. Wait. Well, listen now how it happened.
That nigga mama named him Zerlon.
Zerlon Tipton.
What the fuck do that mean?
Spell it.
Nigga that will shoot himself.
Z-I-R-L-O-N.
It's like Plexico means that in a different language.
Zerlon Tipton. Anyway, he was accidentally shot by his own gun. He was in Detroit attending his daughter's kindergarten graduation when he pulled into a Jeep dealer in the early morning to drop it off for service.
Ow!
As he got out, he was out of his car. He was standing on the outside of the passenger side when he reached in to put his belongings in a bag that he was going to get out, and a gun went off and shot him in the stomach.
Damn. Oh, in the stomach?
Damn. Yeah. Now, wait, he was alive. He was alive when they came, so people were talking to him, so witnesses are saying that he had every notion that he was going to be fine. Like, he's actually...
Why the ambulance taking so long?
He was conversing with them the whole way, but then he...
They thought your name was the street.
Well, he later passed. He later passed the hospital.
Oh,
Eventually. Oh yeah, he died.
There you go.
Freeze. They said he felt he said he talked fine, he was talking to witnesses, but he passed at the hospital. So they said that two guns were eventually found in that bag, though. Now listen, wait. He was only.
Why y'all laughing?
Stop it,
man.
Because you laughing.
Comedy and tragedy.
That brother was like, "Nigga, you think you straight, huh?"
Oh God. Anyway, he was only 26, and look how handsome he is. But back in December now,
that's fucked up.
Wait, back in December now, he was arrested for criminal recklessness in Indianapolis for allegedly firing an assault rifle. I don't know.
Well, live by the gun.
I know, but I'm just saying that he's one to be with the firearm, so I don't know. But they eventually found two guns supposedly in that bag, but it went off by accident. And
it was in a constant.
Well, he left a little baby girl.
Baby girl. I know. I know. And if you look his story up, he's spoken very highly. Everybody speaks highly of him. Like coaches. Other players, his family, people, everybody has.
Man. You have a freak accident like that. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know what? I put that like this. When it's your time, it's your time.
Yeah.
If it's not your time, it's not your time. Mm. When it is your time, it is.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah, that's true.
When it's your time, time's up.
That's it. Man. You don't ever know how it's going to happen.
And it's going to be everybody's time at one point.
At some point.
Hell yeah. Everybody's going to fucking meet their motherfucking maker.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe today. Maybe right now. Roof may cave it. Mm-hmm. Big one might come.
That's tough.
Yeah. Anyway, on the medical side of the game, new news. There's some really interesting treatment now for HIV and AIDS patients. Anyway, they say that you can live easier and longer now by just taking one pill and no longer the need to take what used to be called the AIDS cocktail. And it was an lot of pills throughout the day, various times.
Not my ass, now it's just one pill.
Now it's just one pill, but look, they say that they're calling it ART. It's all capital letters, and it stands
for. You know what they're doing at the Foxhole now.
Shut your. Oh, God, I didn't say that's not right.
Porter's gonna steal that pill.
Anyway, they're calling it ART, which stands for, and let me take my time, antiretroviral therapy. And they say that by taking it, that some people actually, even though they have been diagnosed and have the viruses, that it actually comes up negative, like it's so good, so that people can actually go on and do their, you know, everyday, daily.
Where'd they get this pill?
They've created it. Really? You can look it up. It's, yeah, they're calling it ART.
Do they have
one pill now.
Dr. Sadie? Yeah. Perhaps.
One pill.
They agree.
Yep, there you go.
Somebody called it Cool AIDS.
Ooh, no.
Hey, dude, I'll just pop a Kool AIDS.
Oh. These motherfuckers are stupid in there.
You have HIV.
Pop a Kool AIDS.
Ladies, did you fuck a guy with a lisp? Don't worry, they've got a new pill to help your pussy go back to semi-normal.
Oh, shit.
HIV Away, the new pill by...
Gayco.
Gayco.
What?
By Menin.
By Menin Trouble.
Oh,
God. Man
in trouble.
Stupid. Stupid. Anyway, on another note, even though I just didn't have her just any kind of action, I don't know if you heard about Stacey Dash after Jesse's speech at the BET Awards. Stacey Dash referred to him as a plantation slave. She blogged about it, and she said that it was a racist speech, that he gave a racist speech at the BET Awards, and that he actually attacked white people.
Wow.
She went in on Williams that tough, and...
She's so desperate for relevancy.
Yo, see, that's what I'm saying.
She's not only that, but she's... Man, she... You know what? Everybody hates this chick. I don't mean... You can't hate a dummy, man. You gotta help. It's like the kid, like, come here, you. Put this helmet on and keep it on. Okay.
This is what she said.
Don't take it off, Stacey.
This is her take on it. She said that BET is keeping racism and segregation alive, and this past Sunday's show awards proves it. She said after criticizing various parts of his speech, which you can catch online, still the whole thing. She said she attacked Jesse himself. And she said, "You should. You've just seen the perfect example of a Hollywood plantation slave," she wrote. "Sorry, Mr. Williams, but the fact that you were standing on that stage at those," she did capital in her blog, "awards tells people you really don't know what you're talking about, just spewing hate and anger. Because you, my man, are just like everyone else, hustling to get money. But you're cognitive..."
Bitch, we know about you at the foxhole.
And did she write down... I could just see that after she wrote it, she take a...
She that said, was a big foxhole moment. You can Google that shit. Or
she said, "Did you realize that Black Entertainment is white-owned?" That's what she said.
She could say whatever she want to say, flat out. The rumors about you and a pussy smelling... I mean, am I the only one who heard this? Because I shut the fuck up.
I don't know about the pussy, but I don't like... Well, she used to give these interviews and say how she used to sleep with...
vaginosis. You
know. I've never heard about the vaginosis, but...
I haven't heard about that.
Sorry, Charlie. Starkus already has it to him.
Right.
Oh, Jesus. No, I don't know about that one.
Hey, who's eating sardines in the party?
Who the fuck shitted in a cup?
Oh, stop. Oh.
First and foremost, it's too many assumptions in what she's saying. You assume that BET knew he was going to say that. So you're assuming that.
What did he say?
And what he said wasn't wrong, and it wasn't racist. People have to make a distinction. If I tell you, and I'm coming from an oppressed space, right? I'm a black person, or I'm an Asian, or whoever's been oppressed.
Male, female, whatever.
If we're coming from an oppressed space, telling our story, you can't turn around and say us telling you what happened to us is racist.
Listen,
that's dumb. And for a black person to say it on top of that.
To even justify explaining this chick is
ridiculous. Exactly. That's what I'm saying. Yeah.
It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
She's black
Stephen
Sarah
A.
Taylor.
Smith without the platform.
Well, here we go. She's throwing her name into
anything.
We've got a perfect.
And today in the Italian dogfights, it's Stacey Dash said.
An Italian dog fight.
We got a perfect comeback from him.
Italian dog fighter.
We got a perfect comeback from Jesse, but it wasn't to her.
Shut your dumb ass up.
It was to her directly. But anyway.
A bitch her age who looked like her is supposed to be laid up off some goofy nigga. But you still sitting around talking shit.
She hustling.
Because you are desperate. You might as well hustle your pussy instead of your mouth. Your mouth is only bringing you back down, bitch. Sell that pussy, bitch.
That's right. Ha ha. The joke's on you. I am.
Oh,
I don't have to be. I don't have to be a whore. That's what she thinking. Yes. There's no other way out of the game for you. You got to fuck somebody that can help you. Other than that, bitch, it's been one.
Don't fuck a teacher.
That bitch will be at motherfucking.
It's been one.
It's been one, bitch.
Yeah.
Wrap it up. It's over for you.
But what about my personal things?
I have to say this to be relevant. Ain't nobody coming to see you, bitch.
No. And if she's just really
If she had like events where she went and spoke, who would come?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's really villainizing herself, painting herself into a box, into a corner.
I want attention so bad, I'm going to say fucked up shit so that I can be relevant.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know what? Some white people may come.
Well, we'll listen.
No, they won't.
Listen.
You don't think so?
There's a petition.
Really?
Listen, there's a petition right now. Speaking of Jesse Williams.
White men go see her.
There's a petition, and I'm speaking on this because
it
brings Shonda Rhimes in the game. Homegirl, mega Shonda Rhimes, right?
One of the most powerful
sisters
in Hollywood.
In Hollywood, period. Anyway, she recently responded to this so-called petition that people have put out to her, in a sense, to fire Jesse Williams from Grey's Anatomy after his speech. And so Shonda Rhimes tweeted, and she said, where's her tweet? As you know, she's the creator of Grey's Anatomy.
And a bunch of other shit.
Yep.
Bunch of other stuff. Anyway, she said, "I make stuff up for a living. It's not real, okay? Don't tweet me your craziness." And there's another one. Where's the other one? Go ahead.
What'd she say? Because that sounded like a real Caribbean. What'd she say?
But he came back. What's his name? Jesse. What did I do with it? Oh, dang. I wanted to get that so bad. Because Jesse came back. Cut it out. You're fogging him up, Corey, with your breathing. Dang it. See, now I just lost it. Anyway, Jesse told her, basically told her, you know, don't give these people time. Like, don't even answer them back. You know what I'm saying? Like, he basically has her back too and said, listen, don't egg any of this stuff on. So Shonda came to his aid and just said, basically, he ain't going nowhere.
Jesse gonna grow a ponytail and come on the show.
I wish he would. No, I ran into him. I did. I ran into him after the...
smashed already?
Shut up. He's a very, really good husband.
Fuck with you then.
What do you mean? He was with the pastor of a very famous church out here.
Oh, they all fucking.
Wait, though. Shut up. Everybody, the whole place was full because it was common stuff.
Pastors and porno is the same thing.
Just shush. But anyway, a lot of people were there to...
Be successful as a porn star? Is that her next step?
I don't.
She would have one named Stacey Gash.
She would have a. She
looked just like. I don't Stacey think so. Gash.
She would do better with porn than she is the shit she doing now.
Yeah.
If she had a sex tape with somebody that might be people, you know, somebody like.
You think she isn't writing this down?
Mm.
Sex tape.
Who would be good to fuck her on a sex tape?
Charlie Sheen.
Oh no! Really?
Let's launch her back into Hollywood legitimately.
No, we're talking about one that we want everybody to see.
I would pay for this. I would buy this. I would not bootleg it. I want to see old boy with that fucked up hand finger fucker.
Jason Take Pierre that, Paul. You bitch.
Grab stupid.
Grab her hair with the little fucked up knob.
Oh,
that little gnarl of her hair wrapped that around
little,
that.
A little fat ass milk dud XL.
What the fuck?
Take that, you bitch. Slapping her on her ass, beating the shit out of her with that clump.
Oh. Let me put my thumb in your ass.
Oh.
Hey, wait a minute now.
Wait, stop.
Let me caress you with these little doo-doo nuggets.
His thumb looked like Danny Glover mouth. When he was in that pod. Hit it, Chris.
Go spit, you son of a bitch.
Chris, you're stupid.
Hit it, Chris.
The hell?
You're stupid.
Wow. Oh, I wanted
she
to find
do good,
that.
Man,
darn
as
it.
A porn star, though.
Hey, what?
She might do good as a porn star.
You think so? I don't know.
I think she should go work at like.
But it'll be quick lived. Just like Pinky. Oh, what was her name? What was the
okay,
girl?
Here we go. I found what he responded. And this is perfect, actually, for Stacey herself.
About Jesse?
Yeah. He responded back to. Shonda, and also the other people that were wanting him to get fired. And he said, don't promote empty people in their tantrums. Pure clickbait to gain followers. Attention and money for themselves, not you. Mm. Never you. That's what he said to her.
Is that what he said?
Mm-hmm.
It's amazing.
And this is what she said. People, clickbait. Boo, don't need a petition. Shonda Rhimes rules. Shonda Rhimeland rules. Yes, she does.
I want to say... To everybody who's bold enough to stand up and speak your mind.
On a forum like that, too.
People like Stacey Dash, they're going to try to capitalize off your courage. So all this shit is what it is. Don't even trip off the shit for real. She is trying to... If you didn't say that, she would have said something else outlandish. I hope that bitch have to spend the night at Bill Cosby's house.
It gets like a.
What if she doesn't drink
at the door? Here you go.
Right.
What if she
bottoms up, honey?
Drink it all. Right.
What if she doesn't
Which
drink?
Which way is up, bitch?
You stupid.
Which way is up? Boom, 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 boom.
Hands him. Hands him, bud.
And get some rounds and shit.
That's some old school.
No, he remember that one? James Brown sounds. I can't believe it. I can't stop laughing.
What's that one Richard Pryor movie where he was playing the preacher that got hit by the car because he was fucking old boy wife?
That was, wasn't that Which Way Is Up?
That's
that
Which Way Is Up.
That's Which Way Is Up.
Which Way Is Up. That motherfucker
had
a good saying, soundtrack.
Who fucked your wife? Oh. You lying son of a bitch.
Oh, that movie is classic, man.
Classic.
Mm.
Classic. And the trailer with the... Remember that with the singing teacher? Dude's wife.
Damn, I don't remember.
Speaking
like
of
that.
Stuff like that, when we come back from this break, we're going to talk about fucking other people's
bae. Here we go.
Is there a protocol since it's gone happen?
Wait, what?
Since it's gone happen. That was the curveball right there.
fucking other people's people.
Since it's gonna happen.
OPP, we're gonna have to have Tretch and them on the show.
OPP, that's the yeah, that's the old school word. Do you remember that back when her rap career was cracking?
Very funny, very funny.
I am a nightmare walking, psychopath talking. Kick up a jungle, just a ponytail swalking.
Wait, what? He don't even know what the hell he's talking about.
What? That's the lyric.
He can't remember because his cornrows were too tight around that era, and they fucked with his head.
Hey, y'all tell me, I bet you used to have them beads on the
He had the row. Venus Serena beads.
That was some Chicago. Y'all really did that bead thing a lot. Ooh.
Man, let me tell you something about y'all L.A. niggas.
No, he had the tinfoil at
L.A.
the bottom.
I ain't trying to be bogus, but this the realest shit.
Here we go.
L.A. got the most niggas who fuck their daughters.
Oh, my God. What? Wait, what the hell is he talking about?
Ever since I ain't never heard that.
What?
Nah.
All these bitches be like, I went to my daddy's house and he tried to fuck me.
They telling you because you pay.
What's going on? I think you're talking about the bitches that come to L.A.
Exactly, because right. They ain't
they
from here. They come
here
for a dream.
Wichita,
right.
Because the dad was porking them.
All the finest girls in the country
blame
come
here. For taking up for it, man.
Nah, I don't think.
So many niggas out here fuck their kids.
Who is he talking to? And how do you know? How
that
yeah.
Man, look at their face.
Yeah, that's some bullshit, man.
It happens out here a lot.
I never.
We'll talk about it when we come back.
I
take that back. I do know of a couple of bullshit incidents where that happened.
We're going to talk about it when we come back. 5150.
Wow.
Who Corey hanging around? Yeah.
Shit, they got David West, too.
What's her name? Veronica, you know Veronica.
That was you.
That wrote the book. She wrote a book about it.
Oh, Veronica.
Veronica.
Yeah, got the
yeah.
little Pasadena little
yeah.
magazine. Shit.
Yeah, there's a homegirl. She had a. She was married to a nigga.
This girl out here, I knew, was telling me about her dad went to jail when she was 12. And she was, you know, she's real close to her dad, but he got caught up on the drug his aim or whatever. Mm-hmm. And you know, he got out when she said she was 21. And when he got out, you know, of course she was.
On the real, I don't put anything past a motherfucking man. Any man. Man, anything is possible. I don't never.
Whatever you want, we gon' do that tonight. Got the bag on full and the jewels on bright. Whatever you want, we gon' do that tonight. And what's your name, baby? And where you from? You know my next question. Can I come? I'm like T-Pain and O-Fox. Baby got me sprung. Too cool to show it. Won't lose or blow it either. Just keep spitting my game and rolling reefer. Start talking my foreign shit and showing visas. Told honey I go abroad for Louis sneakers. Lil' Joe put the pussy in the yoke. Next thing I know we lip locking on the boat. Hermes flip-flop, Ferragamo tote, AP Royal Oak. Bezel on coke, other words bouncing off the ceiling in the walls. This the type of feeling you were feeling when you ball. Screaming out the drop head, nigga, fuck the law. What's on?
I've been trying to get him with B-Way.
You back?
That might work.
We back?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, came back quick on y'all puss ass. All my West Coast niggas, I mean my East Coast niggas be talking shit.
I be trying to stay up, nigga. Yo, son, I be mad fucking tired, yo. Motherfucking breaks be mad fucking long. For reals. Bananas,
they
how long you
need. They complaining, though, about the long-ass breaks.
Yeah, so we going to try to keep the breaks shorter, goddammit. Mm-hmm.
But I think the majority of the long breaks came when we were trying to write songs during the break, and then we came back with heaters.
Mm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So sometimes it may happen.
Mm-hmm. You came back with some good songs, man.
We got to get back on our song game.
Yep.
Or at least put out an album. The 5150 album.
Mm. Yep, that's what I say.
That would be crazy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well,
I agree. Well, we started talking about some dark shit. Dark niggas fucking their kids.
Ugh. Wow.
But during the break, Freeze did recollect and thought of shit that he heard of. It ain't just no coast, though. I was just talking
it's
shit.
All over.
It's all over. It's all over.
Yeah, that's it's like, who are you hanging out with?
This is what it is. In all families, it's a nigga that you know something wrong with him. And because he's your family member, you don't be quick to set him out.
Right.
But if it's a man who's in your family, it don't matter if it's your brother, your pops, whoever. If you feel like he will touch children in any way, I really feel like you owe it to yourself to put his ass on blast.
You
owe it to the world to put him on blast.
You owe it to that child to put him on blast.
Yeah.
A lot of times, the family, and sometimes this is the wackest part, because the family will be unified in keeping the secret.
So whack.
Right. And they'll have a gang of dirt, a gang of bullshit that need to be addressed. But just to save face as a family, they dysfunctional as a motherfucker.
All wrong.
Yeah. But they're unified in one thing, and that's keeping whatever dirt they did or whoever did in the family quiet.
So wrong.
That's when you see the strongest unity.
You know you're not supposed to leave no babies with Lorenzo. You know that old shit.
Oh, God.
I wasn't going to leave because Lorenzo was there, but Lorenzo, okay, were you supposed to rush in there and get your kids when Lorenzo show up?
Right.
Nah, somebody should be whooping Lorenzo's ass.
Lorenzo needs to be locked up.
Exactly.
Lorenzo needs to get stomped the fuck out by the family.
Exactly, at once. Now, when Lorenzo come through the door,
this is what happened.
That's real.
What they say?
No, it says uncle and auntie off limits. A frightening look at family sex offenders.
Mm.
Yeah, it's like
real.
It's like, I want to say, this is also a result of the alpha male being ran out of the house. Because I'm just saying, like, you got that nigga back in the day who don't give a fuck who like it or not. Hey! Where that nigga at? When I see that nigga, I'm gonna shoot his ass. Right. But he don't be playing.
Right.
That one nigga they might call Big Papa in the family or something like that. The motherfucker that everybody go get when some shit jump off.
But hold on.
Yeah. You know what I mean?
What they are saying, what's going on is Big Papa is the goddamn problem.
Oh.
You understand?
Oh.
See, that's the thing.
Please, I know what you're saying.
Oh.
But I'm saying, no. A lot of times people... Back
that's
in the day,
in the hood,
we're fortunate enough to have that alpha male.
Right.
Sometimes it might even be a woman. But a lot of times it was that alpha male
that
in the family.
Yeah.
They call him, not the police.
Right.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Right. Yeah. Right.
Mm-hmm.
And then he come
call Jesse them.
Right.
Yep.
You don't call Jesse.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Everybody,
you ain't got to do that.
Don't walk. Why you don't do all that? That ain't that shit.
Hold on, man. See, I feel you. But this is the shit is so fucked up. They done took the alpha male so far out the picture. There's so many families where there is absolutely no recognition, nothing, no alpha male, no one to go to. Mm-hmm. It's time for the pussy ass motherfuckers to stand up too. It's time for everybody who sees it to stand.
The alpha male is out the family, so a woman like Michelle Obama can give a speech about how proud she is. Of Jason Collins for coming out being gay. That is no presence of the alpha male in the family. He gay. Oh, I knew that sick motherfucker was gay. He winked at me one day. I was going to beat his ass. Where's that voice? We have not even heard that voice.
I feel you.
That's a good point.
They silent.
There's no James Evans.
What's the Kardashian's father? They're trying to wipe it out. They're constant.
Caitlyn.
When Caitlyn gave that speech.
I mean Bruce. It's Caitlyn.
The bitch nigga gave the speech.
Motherfucking Bruce.
On ESPN. You didn't hear one motherfucking audience say, boy, if you don't get your stupid ass down from there, you look like a goddamn fool up there.
Yeah.
That voice is needed.
Playing
that
in your voice mama's is clothes.
Yeah.
Got these people looking at you and listening to you while you sit up here and play these silly ass games.
You couldn't
games.
Do anything wrong.
Get down here and put some
grandpa.
Gas in the car, nigga.
Who was it? Was it your dad? Was it
back in the day,
like
there used to be
for
a
me,
certain
it was
thing
my grandpa,
crazy.
Cause my dad didn't live with us. You know
some
saying?
Shit so, is crazy.
My dad was more like that. He had that gleaming look. Like it was like it wasn't a lot. It wasn't loud.
He
just wouldn't play with you. It'd just be like some shit.
Exactly.
Like, but it was an uncle like that. You know, he passed. Of course, you know that was Uncle Howard. Big swole, couldn't stay out of jail. Motherfucker did 500 push-ups in 5 minutes, type nigga. You know what I'm saying? But all I'm saying is, families without a voice like that are missing a lot, man. They missing a lot because there's predators in the family and out the family. Mm. And nobody is checking them motherfuckers except for maybe a loudmouth bitch.
So what's the difference between the uncle or the male predator and the auntie and the female predator? A lot of times, young boys who get molested by a female family member, that shit is like classes in session. They don't see it in the same way.
Molestation.
In our family, they would. That would be old.
I'm not
saying
that.
That has no difference.
But I'm saying
the
male offender gets treated a little differently than the female offender.
Well, that's because of the lack of the presence of the alpha male.
Because I think.
Because he wouldn't give a fuck.
Yeah.
Who, that bitch Jean? She touched who? Wait, I'm
nasty.
Go this bitch out. Get my shit. Yeah.
Who that bitch?
No.
Jane.
Jane, bring your big ass out here.
Don't hide the bitch. Open the door. I know that bitch in there.
Bring your dick sucking ass out here.
Bring your dick sucking ass out here.
This bitch suck Lil June dick.
God, that damn name June really does sound like her.
Lil June.
I know, but I guess.
Somebody went through this shit in here.
Oh,
y'all
God.
Know. Y'all got a story. Them fit that.
Them old school names. Back when it was the alpha male in the family.
Damn this
it.
Bitch suck Lil June's dick.
This bitch over here sucking on Lil June dick. That boy ain't but nine.
Oh my God.
Damn it. Is this the bitch that was sucking Donnie's dick?
Right.
Donnie, show her where to suck. Show your dick where she sucked it.
Lil June.
Lil June said she sucked his dick, and I'm going to shoot that bitch when I see her.
Because remember on Antoine Fisher's story? There was nobody around. That tough late whatever, the mom knew. She knew that stuff was happening. That was terrible, man. That is terrible.
You know, somebody say kneecap stay dirty.
Right. Lil June bug.
Michael Jakes. That's another one of the old school names and shit.
Wear your balls. Look at Auntie. Right. Wear your balls.
My pop's nickname, you know, they all from Alabama, was Baymane.
Uh-oh.
What was it?
Baymane. That's what they used to call him. Hey, Baymane.
My pop's nickname was Polar Bear.
Polar Bear.
Uh-oh.
Polar Bear.
Polar Bear.
Polar son. I love Polar.
That little Polar. Now we got to see a picture.
Your dad used to be a biker.
Polar.
What did he have a nickname?
My dad was a biker. No.
Everybody just called him what?
Pete.
Yeah. My dad was a military police officer. And
don't
his
play with Pete.
His nickname was Gus.
Gus.
But my dad was a biker. Nobody messed with me when I was a little. Yeah.
Fucking Gus,
fucking
what was that boy's name on that movie?
You just gonna let Gus catch you with any weed?
Jaws, what was that motherfucker name he kept calling old boy?
Which one?
The old motherfucker. He was
what?
He had a doll's eyes.
No, right,
the drunk guy.
Well, he was calling the nigga with the glasses. What did he call it? Cooper, the Hooper.
Hooper.
Get the water out the boat, you son of a bitch.
What you trying to say? Hooper did some things?
No,
anyway, but
old school names, but I'm just saying, real talk.
Family's got a
I'm
lot
sure
of shit,
there's shit going
uncovered.
On right now. Yeah. And this is like the type of topic that is really awkward to get into because it's just some awkward shit when it happened. But it's common.
Yeah.
Well, what should be the first thing that, like, if you find out, should you keep it in-house? Should you call the cops? Because a lot of times when we keep it in-house, violence is going to happen. Somebody's going to get beat up. Somebody's going to get shot. When you find out a family member has been abusing another family member, I'm just saying, what is the course of action that should be taken?
Any of you guys recall that story?
There was not long ago, there was a father who found out that his 11-year-old
and he beat him. Yep, I saw that.
Was getting raped by an older cousin or a neighbor or somebody that was there all the time.
Yeah.
When he found out, he changed that. That nigga looked like Mr. Potato Head for real.
Yeah, I saw that.
And you know what?
The lumpy lumps.
And you know what? They let it rot. Said, hey, man. Because think about it. If you walk, he walked in on him, though. So, you know.
And they had his son's pants on.
It's like, oh. And he let him.
He rocked the by baby.
Ballooned his head up. Gave him a pumpkin head on the spot.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. But, y'all, check this out.
And he let it ride. They had no recourse.
That's amazing.
Ask that question one more time, Zoe.
I was just saying, what should be, you know, the course of action? Should you keep it in-house and deal with it in-house, or should you call the police? What steps should you take?
If somebody is touching your child, there is no course of action.
Right.
Everything go.
Everything is legal.
Hitting with an iron?
Go for broke. Yes. Yep.
Hitting with an ironing board. Yes.
Run him over with a car.
Yes.
Car.
Yes. You fuck with the kids.
Yes.
Yes. It's all legal.
The world can drop on your punk ass, nigga. That's what I feel.
The world.
The entire world.
I don't want to hear no excuses from niggas who fuck with kids.
None. Right. There is no excuse.
Because some niggas be like, you don't know what I've been through. All that shit.
I know what you're going through right now, nigga.
That's what I'm saying.
People are going through hell, nigga. Starting now.
If you fuck with the kids.
You fucked up, baby.
You can't tell me shit. It happened to that nigga that I'm going to say, that's fucked up.
Right. You didn't have to do all that.
Right.
No, yes, you did.
Please.
That pumpkin head was a blessing.
Because it could have been way worse.
Man, I'm telling you, man, there's some motherfuckers out here, man, who going to snap. They ain't going to give a fuck.
Right.
Yeah. I'm one
about no repercussions.
I'm one of them. If you put your hands on somebody's child.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Like that. You changed my child, nigga.
Yeah. You changed him forever.
I'm changing you forever, nigga.
Right.
I'm changing you forever.
Right. You're about to change.
And guess what? I feel that's my duty.
Oh, yeah.
Man, look. Can you look any judge in the eye and say, if you want to try me and make drama for my life after handling my business, there's nothing I could do about it.
Mm.
But I wasn't going to let that motherfucker walk. Like, let me tell you something, man. It's easy to say what you would do, you know what I'm saying, if something happened.
Right.
Mm.
But
I hope none of us are ever tested in that.
Right, because it's the worst shit in the world.
I don't want to ever be tested in that.
When I watched television during that Trayvon trial, I swear to God, I was just sitting up thinking, like, I want to pop that nigga for him.
Yeah, like if you saw him in the street, that's what everybody was thinking. I was thinking
pop
the same
that
thing.
Motherfucker.
Any father who had a son, who has a son, who's in a son's life, who's molded a son, watch that fucking trial.
Oof.
Dude, everybody was like, what?
This is what changed me. Well, I never forgot it. When that little boy was fighting for his life, and that motherfucker said, that's me screaming. And his mama say, that's my son. I know his voice. Man, let me tell you something, man. That motherfucker Zimmerman, after that shit.
He's walking this earth. I can't believe it still.
See what I'm saying? It's a million stories like this, but that one played out in front of us. And you know what I'm saying? His family was all happy when he got out and all that shit. Man, let me tell you something, man. We don't have that eye for an eye mentality. And it is making it where people aren't scared to put their hands on our kids.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Barack Obama, when he talks shit about what's happening in Baltimore streets, he spoke bad on the protests, but didn't speak bad on what happened to the youngster.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? That gives people the courage to put their hands
on
your kids.
Shit. Yeah, yeah.
Look. I listened to that brother David Banner CD. Fucking fire.
It's ridiculous.
Fucking fire.
In case you missed it last week.
Man, I listened to the shit. The shit was dope. And he said some dope shit. Mm-hmm. If a black cop kill a white kid, they gonna go to his house and drag him out there.
They gonna
motherfucker.
Come get him. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You're not finna walk around this earth after your black ass done shot one of our kids. Mm. But white cops shoot black kids all the time. They the same thing as a predator who sexually molests a child.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And don't nothing happen.
Mm.
Real.
Hey, I like
we that. Don't make it our business to go to his house right. and pull his family out and do something to them. Because then people will be like, oh, you preaching hate.
Right. Or you're a racist.
Mm-hmm. Shut the fuck up. That motherfucker who shot that boy in St. Louis,
yeah.
who was unarmed.
Yeah.
The one playing with the gun.
Somebody
the park,
told me
bacon?
I was wrong for saying this, but I stand on this. His family should have been in danger. That cop, his family should have been in danger. They should have dragged his family out. Because if you ain't got an eye for an eye mentality, the motherfucker gonna keep killing the kids, cause it ain't no repercussion.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. The fuck, you ain't gonna do shit.
It's this shit is that's a heavy ass motherfucking mind game, baby. Think about it. Think about that. That they got us to where we are not moving, not dragging these motherfuckers out there. How is that, man?
You took the alpha male out the house. Yeah. The alpha male. I'm talking about the moral alpha male who don't play. All the niggas in the neighborhood know, oh, Charles ain't bullshitting. If he said that's what it is, that's what it is.
Yeah,
hey, man, the motherfuckers done shot my nephew out here.
He makes his own court, right?
Them motherfuckers be like, what?
Mm-hmm.
Man, mount up.
It's real.
Charles finna go over there. That's my man. I'm not finna leave him by himself. That's a good man. If he over there doing that, now everybody hate everybody like a bunch of bitches.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
That's real.
And here's a check, and here's a degree, and you're doing better. Without the moral male voice in the
and
crib.
Now shut up.
Now you shut up. Yeah. Now you're doing good. Mm-hmm. You're better educated. Dad's not pushing you to
don't
greatness.
Don't rock any boats.
Don't rock any boats.
Keep
Be
it
quiet.
Smooth.
And that's some
people,
bullshit.
It's natural to feel fear because you are outgunned. It's natural to feel that.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
But one day something's going to jump off. And motherfuckers going, you're not going to be able to say, let's stop, y'all.
Right.
Because it's going to be on.
You're right. not supposed to fear shit, man.
Right.
And that's real. I'm not sorry. Your, We're not supposed, kids. None of us are supposed to fear this right. shit. I can remember as a kid, when we talking about 1970.
Mm-hmm.
I can remember because, I can remember anyway. My pops told me this nigga, I said, Daddy, I said, what happens if the police come? Because I saw the police in going down over someplace, and he said, don't shit happen. They stay their ass on the other side of that door. Don't you ever let them in this. This is my house.
Mm.
This is America. Can't nobody kick open no door or nothing. You understand that? And I mean that, son. Don't let nobody ever in your house.
And since Obama has been in office, they have laws now where they had a right to purge in your house.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, come the purge in. Is real now.
Oh, yeah. yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They can come in
it.
Your house and detain you without no reason.
Mm-hmm. Martial
right.
law.
Mm-hmm. All that bullshit. They sneak in and we out here buying all these new motherfucking gadgets and getting these
and
new apps.
People don't understand. While you busy consuming, they're doing war games preparing for detaining enemy combatants. Well, who are the enemy combatants? Mm-hmm. American citizens now.
I'm just buying a sweater.
Right. Now they're seeing the American citizen as the terrorist.
Man, you know what? I'm a name drop because, you know, I met this nigga, and this a real-ass motherfucking nigga.
Mm-hmm.
And I know he wouldn't give a fuck if I said it. So that's why I'm a name drop.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I was on the phone talking to Charlie Murphy this week.
Charlie Murphy.
Yeah.
And he said some shit that I just actually agree with. It don't mean that I hate these people, because I don't, because they are me.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But he said, damn, I don't know if I should say it like that. But fuck it. That nigga, you know that nigga better than me. He don't give a fuck.
That's Donnie, man. He stand on what he say.
He stand on 100%. That shit. This is what he said, and I agree. He said that the black woman is assisting the white man and bringing down the community. And I agree with that, because for every case you put on the father of your child, you only take more power away from his ability to get shit done in this world. And if you know how many black women have cases that are based on money against the father of their child, how the fuck can you be out here talking shit about what's going on and you part of the white man's game to fuck the whole community up? Because everybody got a fucking case because they had a child. And a bitch will say, well, he need to take care of his child. Bitch, putting a case on a man where he don't have a driver's license and passport ain't got nothing to do with him taking care of his
and
child.
And that goes with...
And
if
you
fucking clearly...
Fuck with a nigga that won't take care of his child, bitch, who are you?
Right. And it's clearly a racist
system.
That's
true, you chose him.
It's like going to the devil for a solution to a problem that the devil put
in. And it's
in
not
play.
Just black women, exactly. But I hear what you're saying, though, Corey, because there's
no,
a lot
it's
of...
not just black women,
it's,
because...
I think it's an era.
Mexican
it's,
women,
the, it's an era.
Let me tell you something about the Mexican women in L.A. They got cases on their baby daddies, too.
Oh, I'm agreeing. That's why I'm saying.
They falling for that system shit. All the people who... Man, look. You.
But listen, if we...
I say this to the women out there who doing that shit. You know that you don't want nobody doing that to your son.
That's what I say to the women that's doing that. Fuck you, you raggedy-ass bitch.
Damn. You got a son. These bitches' son grow up. And they realize by the time he about 20, I can't even help him. Because I raised him like a bitch.
Mm.
And now he finna fall into the same fucking web his daddy fell into, where this bitch is about to put a case on him.
Because it ain't their
some
son.
Bullshit.
It's her son.
Right. You hear that a lot.
They That's a mentality in the hood.
Exactly. And they tell them that.
It ain't our kid.
Right.
It's my kid. And if you want it to be our kid, you got to break bread.
And come talk to the white
There's
man.
There's too many. Listen. There's too many other currencies. The money is important, 100. You're going to have to find a way to give your kid money, period. But presence is a currency. Communication is a currency. When a father sits down and downloads his philosophy into his son, that's a priceless fucking currency.
But you see,
that don't exist that, either, though.
That
though.
Is
but
what
that
they
don't
do
exist
not
either.
Want.
That's
precisely what they
want. That's almost non-existent,
that does
too.
Exist.
What don't
that's
they
almost
want,
non-existent
they
as
do
well.
Not want.
That's not almost non-existent.
Wait a minute. Hold on 1 second. What was you saying?
That's almost non-existent as well.
What is?
You
what
got
is?
The same. Those women that you're talking about, not all the guys that they messed with either got any sense and want to be in their kids' lives either, too. If you look at the percentages.
Okay.
None of those guys are around.
I definitely
concerned.
Want to respond to that, but go ahead.
You
friends.
Really think that that's a lot of them out there
See,
that do that?
See, here's the thing. In the beginning, this is the ideal guy. You like the way this guy
Whoop.
Thinks.
Whoop.
This guy is—he thinks so well.
Yeah.
He's gonna get that ass.
Ha!
He's in there. This is Mr. Wonderful.
That
but
dude.
But then you don't like Mr. Wonderful anymore because Mr. Wonderful says some shit that you don't agree with.
Mm.
Right.
You agreed with it when you liked him, but now that you don't like him, you don't agree with him. So therefore,
wait.
You're going to stop, and anybody that's out of spite, out of anger, out of hurt, that he didn't agree with your view, he didn't see things the way you saw. So rather than say, like in the olden days, a lot of women would say, well, you know what? You the husband, you the father of this, I'm going to ride this out, and I'm going to I'm going to do as a woman and as a mother.
Mm.
I'm going to still do it. But I'm not going to push you away. I'm not going to set it up to
what
where
you mean?
Your philosophy, your way of thinking can be implicated into your kids' lives. That's what they don't want, because that's the same philosophy that said, wait a minute, this is a raggedy bitch.
Uh-oh.
If you grow up in a house where you have never seen your mother communicate
with
bond,
exactly.
Put together something with a man.
Mm-hmm.
Right, that's major.
When you hit this world, never seeing your mother basically collaborate with a man in a way to make things happen. You handicapped.
You are.
For
you,
sure.
You are worse than a motherfucker who has one of those diseases that make his hand do that. You handicapped. you didn't even see your mother put it together with a man to make something happen. Mm. So you got all these kids, men and women in the world, handicapped, don't even know how to create a family, don't know how to create a bond with another human being, don't know how to pick a human being worth creating a bond with. So now, basically, we are just, this is some racist sounding shit I'm finna say, but
you on it right where
we act like Caucasian people act. I'm just saying, where the kids talk to the parents like they the boss. Because right. We don't know how to motherfucking make a family.
Well, you can't even discipline your because you never kid saw it coming up. You can't even discipline
you
the
can
kid
discipline
way you
discipline your kids. Corey just said something. You can. You can. But you got to be willing to go to the system.
No, but that's what
well,
I'm
you,
saying.
You can discipline, but you got to start that early. You can't get progressively authoritarian as they get progressively... defiant.
You got to watch.
You got
to
start with them early.
Right.
So by the time they get to a certain age, they've already been conditioned on how you gonna respond when they not listening.
I heard that.
And mind
yeah.
you,
but
hold on.
He just said something and I need to. We'll finish it.
All I'm saying, a lot of the reasons that people can't discipline their kids is because people never learned how to discipline kids, and it goes way too far. So I understand it. Right. I understand. You got to pump brakes because some motherfuckers don't know. They'll be like, oh,
some
this,
will whoop out of anger,
this,
out of frustration.
Right, this your report card? Go get in front of the car, motherfucker.
Something else that's missing besides that not knowing how to put a family together. Because we are all separate. The truth is most people keep their shit away from the world.
Mm-hmm.
Most people don't want you in their house.
Mm-hmm.
Because we don't have the type of bond in a village type of community where the weak can see how the strong act.
Mm-hmm.
Because right. the strong here are the ones who call the police, the ones who do shit like Stephen A. Smith do. Those are the ones considered the strong, whereas at one time, the strong was the motherfuckers like we was talking about,
the
alpha
village.
Male in the house. Who motherfucking wasn't finna be ran by nobody he's not supposed to be ran by. Meaning like, I know good niggas who not really coward motherfuckers. They just don't want to be arguing and going to jail with their woman.
Bullshit.
So they don't even know. Every time you let her do something to basically make you give up on your backbone as a man. And eventually you just a puppet in her hand.
Right.
You destroying your kids because they see that too.
They see that bullshit too. Exactly.
I'm not saying the man is supposed to be the smartest one in the house.
Right.
Mm-hmm. But I'm here to tell you.
He's not supposed to be the lapdog.
You took the words out of my mouth.
That's bullshit.
Kids watch you be a lapdog to your woman.
Right.
And
that's some bullshit.
It's weak.
I agree.
And if your woman is the motherfucker that's going to bark, she better be a strong woman because she got to guide them kids the right way.
Right.
You might see me be this way, but that's the man. You the motherfucking kid, and I'm the motherfucking, I'm the mother. You know
and
what
I'm
saying?
And we gonna follow this protocol.
Yeah.
And we gonna build something. You because said something about black people acting just like white people. Now, I'm gonna pose this, and then we'll see how we deal with it from there. Whenever someone like Jesse Williams steps up and says something, the white establishment will jump out and say, oh, well, what he said was racist. Well, the same thing applies to black men who step up and say stuff like you just said, like you two just said, about black women. They fight us like the white system is fighting Jesse. Just because we step up and say, hey, hold on. There's an order. There's a protocol. There's a lack of a strong man in the household. Mm-hmm. You done took the baby and made him yours. Then you raised him to a certain point to where you can't help him no more. And you wish you would have let his daddy in. You wish you would have let his daddy participate. But you think you're in control. The whole system's out of order. But they push back at us the same way the system pushes back at us when we stand up and say, hey, wait a minute. To me, that's the clearest indicator that our sisters, no disrespect, a great majority of our sisters are thinking with a white supremacist mind.
Not even knowing it most of the time.
Not even knowing
it. They don't even have it yet.
Unconsciously.
Unconsciously, yeah.
Your degrees, your great job, your being acknowledged by this system
means nothing when your family is out of order.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
It's
yeah.
real.
The yeah. father don't fuck with you. And the child is almost bold enough to say, bitch, shut the fuck up.
But
you, yeah, they were yeah. about nine. They almost
Ooh,
about,
that's right.
I remember when that bitch called me about my daughter. You need to come get her.
Uh-oh. What?
Come get her now, huh, bitch?
Right.
What happened? All that bullshit that happened when the child raised up. And I ain't gonna even lie. I know shit that happened with my daughter where I expect her to raise up against her mama because she unfortunately has a mama that's jealous against her. And I've always known that. You know what I'm saying? My daughter's mother was jealous of her. When I used to buy my daughter real nice shit, her mama would say, where mine at? And that made me be like, who the fuck even thinks like that? Bitch, I don't owe you shit.
Right. Be happy that a daddy is involved in his daughter's life, buying her shit. How do you interject you into that picture?
Warped thinking begats warped thinking begats warped thinking over and over and over and over again.
Generations.
I would say to all of the women out there who are single raising a child, they have taught you that what you're doing is right. But I just want you to know, if that child ain't never seen you build a bond with a man, that child is going to go into this world without the tools necessary. Because building a bond with a man, whether he's a little boy watching his mama or a little girl watching his mama, they going to treat men how you treat men.
Right. Little girl watching her mama.
Right. Yeah. But the flip side of that is this. It's unfortunate, but the white supremacist system that is prevailing right now for the dominant culture is the only system sisters know.
No.
That's the only system
and they
of success.
So easy. They made it easy.
That women know. So until brothers get together, unify, fortify, and continue to build with each other and build a different reality, that's the only thing they can run to. That's it.
Somebody in the chat room I saw, it said, what if it's a weak nigga who allowed that, et cetera, et cetera. Well, this is what I want to say about weak niggas. Weak niggas have been allowed to blossom because...
Flourish.
Yeah, to blossom and flourish, all that shit. They out here in numbers like that because... Mm-hmm. This is why. Because of the same thing I said.
Thumbs can really go.
The woman who is lost will pick a weak man over the strong man because she is about what she wants.
Right.
And when you brought up right, you understand what I want normally ain't good for me. I need to get with what want me and what I need.
Right, what's best for me.
Right.
Mm-hmm. What's best for us? What's best for this family?
How many girls you know? I'm talking about girls you know who fuck with a man who you know ain't shit. She know ain't shit. And she is already, everything has been put out there. And she fuck with him and it ain't nothing you could tell her even though she know. You her brother, well, you her friend, you her whatever. That's a girl who grew
this
up.
This is what I call, you breaking down something heavy. This is what I call the utility man.
Exactly.
Because that tool. Motherfucker is a tool. She uses him to facilitate certain things in her life.
He's like a piece of equipment.
He's like a fucking...
She's like, girl, I got my car.
He's a
rabbit. I got Gerald. Gerald, come here.
Right.
Gerald, yeah. Did you fix that light?
Listen,
Gerald,
most alpha men only do shit in service of others for a short time. Because most alpha men are trying to blaze their own trail. So they might do some shit in service of someone else to learn something, to gain something intellectually, how to figure it out, how to do it.
But don't get out of place.
They gonna be off doing their shit. That's men shit. That's why a lot of men don't go to church.
Back during before we were colonized in this shit, man. I'm telling you, man, when we lived in villages, the men would get together and do and say what needed to be done to keep the village strong.
Right. Mm.
Like when you was a boy and you reached a certain age, there were tests you had to go through to prepare you for manhood and to be a soldier in the village.
Like nigga jump rites from that roof to that roof.
Right. That's what it's called, rites of passage. Mm-hmm.
You're going to be a soldier in this village. Mm-hmm. You finna motherfucking prove yourself. You finna go out here in this world and become what you need to become.
And get your own food.
Now, in this world we live in, if your son wants to say he a woman, he should be able to call himself a woman, and you wrong for saying he's not a woman.
And you should be out helping him pick out his dress.
Wow.
That's a good father.
Wow. Wow. First off, you ladies, let me just say, you can't raise a son without telling him the truth about his father. And then once you tell him the truth about his father, get out of the way and let him discover if what you said was true. Let him discover on his own.
I agree.
Do you understand? Mm. There's 23 chromosomes from you and 23 chromosomes from dad. You put them together, you get 46. That's that man's living book. 23 chapters from you, 23 chapters from pops. Get the fuck out the way and let him read those other 23 chapters. Because as long as you think your book is enough information to sustain him, he will be lost. He will be half of himself. Mm. And that's the key. Mm.
Lopsided.
Yeah.
And if pops ain't around, don't you have any alpha uncles? You know what I'm saying?
Alpha granddaddy?
A granddaddy, a coach, something, brothers?
Coach, they're, you know.
A lot of times they don't fuck with that bitch because she's scandalous.
I'm just saying,
this is how it go. Motherfuckers be sugarcoating shit because they be scared to make the women mad at them. It's a lot of scandalous bitches out here.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And motherfuckers in their family don't fuck with them.
There's plenty of alpha males. Only problem is your mama ran through all of them.
Oh, God.
Mama got an alpha womb.
Oh, God.
Oh.
That womb got the Barry White boys that's been fucked so much.
My secret.
Put that dick in here, Nick.
I'll take good care of you. And I'll be there.
There's something wrong with me.
Oh, shit. No, but there's some fucked up brothers, too. Brothers, we got to do better. For real, we all got to do better. We all flawed. But I'm going to tell you this. Motherfuckers is looking at martial law right now.
Oh, man.
And niggas
down.
Is worried about the next Jordan.
Shit.
Niggas is worrying about motherfuckers switching teams on the NBA. It's some real shit happening in the world that requires our cooperation with each other.
Right.
In order to sustain and survive.
The shit that concerns us, we are not concerned with. And the shit that does not concern us, we're concerned with.
Niggas need to have...
Shit.
People need to be in the desert having to hunt again.
People thought I was crazy growing up because
you can go to the grocery store and basically get what you need to eat till you die. Mm-hmm. It makes you weak. If you don't hunt...
Mm-hmm.
You fucking a shell of yourself.
Right.
Yeah.
You've never tapped the potential that you should tap in order to be where you need to be to make the hair stick up on your back the right way.
And not only hunt, grow, nigga.
Right.
Put something in the
just
dirt.
Anything.
Man.
Use your hands.
If you don't look,
let it rise.
Hey, Freeze. If you don't hunt, you ain't gonna grow because you ain't gonna eat.
That's true.
And you gonna die. And when motherfuckers know they gonna die if they don't catch some shit to eat. That's when you see who a motherfucker really could be.
Right.
You got to do it all.
Right.
Really.
And you guys are saying something that's real powerful, especially just on the ground floor level of survival. It's a lot of niggas that don't know how to fucking string a worm
they
on
can't
a hook.
Even change
a
tire.
And
what
go fishing. It's a lot of niggas that nowadays that don't even know how to fish. So I understand the hunt.
It's a lot of bras don't even know how to cook fish.
Mm-hmm.
Right. But I'm going to say this, too.
Don't know how to catch it. Bros don't know how to cook it.
I'm going to say this, too. Yo. The hustle and hunting
true.
Are the same thing. Hustling is hunting. And sometimes being an entrepreneur, you got to hustle and hunt the next great idea. And once you catch the next great idea, you've got to develop it and cultivate it. Now, I'm going to tell you right now, it's hard as fuck to catch a great idea, develop it, and cultivate it in a household of chaos.
Almost
where you got a motherfucker.
Almost impossible.
Do you understand what I'm saying? So just basic family building requires a woman to say, yeah, we might be doing bad, but this motherfucker just caught the next great thing. So am I going to just be mad we ain't got pet milk right now? Or am I going to put some energy into what this idea is, especially if it's a good one? I'm not talking about a 65-year-old nigga who want to rap, right? I'm not talking about that nigga who want to come out of retirement and start breakdancing. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about a motherfucker
and
who might come up with a meaningful idea.
If the nigga can rap and breakdance, that could be profitable.
At 65.
At 65.
That might make some of it.
Vegas and the circus.
If that nigga can see it, ride with him, goddammit.
But I hear what you're saying, though. You're right.
Well, if a motherfucker got hustle, it's going to show.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Because most motherfuckers I know find ways out of no ways. I mean, I wonder how I pay the motherfucking rent. Keeping it real.
Right.
I mean, when I moved out of here one day on my birthday, I had made enough money to pay my rent. I was so motherfucking happy. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because, shit, when you come from nothing, I don't know how motherfuckers used to come up with a certain amount every month just to live there.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Because right. I grew up on Section 8 and shit
right.
like that.
Mm-hmm. Me too.
The type
shit.
Of rent where you can get that.
Nigga, $50
but this
a
is,
month.
This is L.A., nigga.
Oh, God. Yeah.
Nigga, this rent out here.
Is for real.
Motherfuckers don't even believe it when you tell them from you, when you go to other parts of the country.
Right.
You got to
right.
go to more like, south. If you go to south, like where my folks
get a
live,
six-bedroom house
you can get real good. You get real reasonable.
Well, if you live in L.A. County, goddammit.
That's right.
You're getting robbed.
Yeah. Rob.
Way
and if you
robbed.
Ain't got no hustle,
Rob,
that Midnight
Rob.
Train to Georgia song, real, then a month.
Okay. L.A., too much for the man.
That's right.
He couldn't make it.
Going back to a place in less complicated time.
Woo-hoo!
Man.
Don't spit, you son of a bitch.
But
it's a cold world, man. Out here in L.A., man. So as far as it go with that family shit, though, man, I'm just saying, man, I would tell all single mothers, you can't trust nobody around your kids. And also, you have been taught that what you're doing by yourself is right.
Or is enough.
Yeah, I don't like when you hear the...
The truth is, it's
I don't
not.
Need a man.
And if you never find a man, that don't mean you wrong. But if you find a man, and that motherfucker ain't got your back, and you got him up under your kids,
ugh.
He's slowly resenting and hating and not participating.
Oh, and they're gonna be a mess too, because they're hating. Yeah.
You might as well shoot venom into your kids.
Yeah, already.
But they'd rather shoot semen into their pussy. Now let's just keep. How many women have chosen dick over their children?
See.
Yeah, exactly. That's a
and
lot.
And then want a motherfucking Mother's
too.
And Father's Day card.
And the kids to act right.
Now look. Now look. When Jimmy come over, you sit up and go into your room.
Right.
you
that.
You put on Netflix. I put some pudding in your room.
Yeah, take these M&Ms too.
Right.
If a man will hit you in front of kids that ain't even his.
Mm.
Something wrong with that nigga.
Get the fuck out of here.
Because I'm just saying, like, if I ain't with you like that, first of all, any signs of motherfucker. I got to a bitch with a over the channel on the TV, and I was like, this bitch just yelled at me in front of her daughter. I want to watch this. I was like, oh, go ahead. Huh? I left something in the car. I'll be right back. I'm the ghost mood king.
Yo, for real, I'm telling you, man, I had one broad like that. When I got in the car, I realized she had a baby in the car seat.
Oh.
I'm like, oh. She said, yeah, I couldn't get a babysitter. I was like, okay. Wow, I didn't even know you had a baby, but it's all good. Then she took out a Newport and lit that shit. I was like, in front of the baby. Motherfucker, if I want to smoke. I was like,
oh,
I got you.
All I need to know.
Hey, hold on. I'm going to run into this store and run out the back.
Yeah. Right.
Out of here, bitch. Mm.
I know a girl who got a four-month-old baby, and she went to the club and got drunk one night, and the person who was babysitting was explaining to her, you know, it's fucked up that you didn't tell me you was going to be gone all night, and you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And the girl's whole excuse was, this is my first time doing this since I had a baby. Do you need to hear more? Right. You know what I mean when I say that? Like, she justified that shit.
It is just too easy for them just to have a baby and for people to get married. They need to make some sort of damn freaking certifications or a license or something, because it is just
Certified mama and a certified daddy.
It's crazy, man.
A course to be certified. I got a license to be a.
Y'all ever fucked in front of a girl, baby? I've done it before.
Wait a minute.
Maybe your own kids.
When I was a young man, this girl had her baby in the bed while we was fucking, and I'm not making
this up. Yeah, but how old was the baby? Was it under one?
Baby was young. Under one.
I'm trying to remember.
Also, it was a baby. It wasn't a toddler.
It was a baby baby.
A newborn. Oh, come on.
Your actual fucking motion put the baby to sleep.
Right.
That's what you're saying.
No, the baby was
a newborn.
The baby was already asleep. And we got it in quietly as we may have been, because she was like,
don't wake the baby.
Right.
Oh, now this baby is a child.
So I'm like,
reoccurring nightmares.
I mean, what do you think about that? Could that be your woman?
Yeah.
I remember when my daughter
wasn't your baby.
No.
See, that's the difference. I was going to say, we as a family,
my daughter was.
Baby's laying on the bed like a discarded leather jacket.
Ooh.
You understand?
Whose baby is
that? Wow, I didn't know that was a baby. I thought that was
you almost rolled over on it?
I mean, what am I arguing with her for? That's what I was saying. I was like, I don't know her.
Stick and move, brother.
Right.
But you're not going to make a thing of it and keep seeing her, right?
See, no, she's not. She's not worthy of being kept.
Right. That's
a if you're a
stranger with your baby in the bed because the baby young and can't comprehend what's happening and she sleep, it's okay.
It's not okay. No. But you got some simps who will stay with that situation thinking that woman is a good woman. This man will sit there and watch this woman talk to the baby that he fucked in front of, crazy to the motherfucker, and think that shit will never happen to him.
Right.
Mm. It's that kind of nigga just be sitting there like, she's going off on that nigga. Yeah, get that nigga. But that's the same shit she gonna do to you when the opportunity presents itself.
That's real. You wanna see how you gonna be treated in a relationship?
Right.
Male or female, whoever you are, see how that other person treats their people. See how they treat their parents. Parents.
Yes.
See how they treat their brothers and sisters.
Right.
Because that is precisely how they're going to treat you.
Yep, how they treat
you. When
I
was a young man, my daughter's mother had a nigga up there when my baby was probably about maybe 3 months, whatever. And I was a young nigga. I don't know how old
I
was.
So you flexed off.
I was buzzing the bell, knocking on the door.
Yeah.
Because it was my first time ever experiencing something like that. I was like, because, you know, we broke up, but this bitch had some nigga over there. And then she called the police. And then the police, I don't even know if I said this shit before. The police officer, I got lucky. They put me in the car, and they drove me to the train station because they realized I didn't have a car.
Wow.
And he told me, he said this, and I never forget it. And it was a Caucasian man. He said, there's nothing you can do about that.
That's it.
But I was so shocked that she would be fucking some other dude with my
baby
newborn
in
the house.
Well, your baby didn't mean nothing to her.
That's my daughter's
or
mom.
Him.
And what's crazy is...
This is the same
they
one...
They will argue that child means everything. But then if you question that right there, you're the racist.
How dare you question my motherhood? I'm telling you, sisters will respond to us in the same way white supremacy is responding to Jesse Williams. Mm. How dare you question my motherhood? Wait a minute. It's okay for you to fuck another dude.
Mm. Somebody said police 90 Uber.
Days,
that's
90 days after you had our child. Mm. 90 days. The baby right there. It's okay.
You're not even supposed to be having intercourse in the first place, but go ahead. You're supposed to wait 6 months.
Hey, on, nigga, I hope you know you got afterbirth on your dick.
Oh, and then her stuff didn't heal up right.
And then too. you are a hater.
I was a young
you
man.
You hate women.
I was
you,
in shock.
If you ask that question.
Because that was my bitch, but my baby was up there. That's what I just kept saying. My baby is up there.
Wow. Mm.
That's why it ain't too much can shock me because my daughter's mother showed me how cold a bitch can be.
Mm. Right. And I like the way you said, hey, bitch. Them bitches are colloquialism. Let's not get into semantics. Hey, bitch. Not all. Hey. You know, women can be some of the coldest in the world.
Shit.
And men can be, too.
Men can be, too.
But my people point is this. My point is this. I keep going back to this. Man, the world is changing faster than you can blink. And the only way for us to have any type of footing moving forward is some type of participation, some type of cooperation, collaboration. Mm-hmm. And if we don't have that, and all we got is disrespect and angst for each other, I'm telling you, we gonna suffer the most. When I sit and I look up in the Arctic, you can go on to YouTube and find it. There's a whole fucking documentary about it. These rich white motherfuckers like Zuckerberg and Gates and all these motherfuckers, they own all of the seeds. They got a seed bank in Norway. And all of the countries around the world send them their original seeds. What the fuck are you planning? Mm-hmm. And while niggas is at the mall, and while niggas is fucking around trying to figure out who Jocelyn and Stevie gonna fuck next, you understand what I'm saying?
Yep.
We on the bullshit.
Going down in my DM.
Right.
Go down.
What's going down in the DM? These motherfuckers is planning the next movement. Mm. The fucking United States government just bought billions of bullets. They bought billions of bullets and coffins. They got the seed bank in Norway, and niggas is still mad at each other?
Mm-hmm. Well, you know what, Zoe?
Oh, come on.
Like, when you say that shit, man, you know, you put it in context, man. It's like, anybody who's aware of what's happening in the world, you have to feel like, oh, my God, what the fuck can I do to catch up? You know, to show my people, do you realize that all them bitches, the housewives of Atlanta, all that shit is decoy shit.
Decoy.
To stop you from being able to pay attention to what you need to pay attention for.
World star hip hop, all that stuff.
Right.
All that shit. Fighting, all that.
Man, I'm telling you, the brother David Banner said it in his CD about when he went to other countries. And he saw how we were portrayed on the TV.
Right.
That joke,
with the dancing and all that sucker puffy shit that all them goof ass niggas started. Shit. I remember when all that shit became the new music on BET and everything. It's all dancing and bragging.
Man.
It ain't no culture to this shit.
No.
Them niggas folded the game.
Right.
Puffy them. Them niggas fold this shit. Just like whack niggas who steal jokes. They fold up the comedy game.
Right.
You can't have no Comic View no more.
Right.
Because that company put on whack niggas without going out and finding real talent. Mm. So now that shit became nothing.
Right. Mm.
Same thing.
No
rap game, everything.
All the motherfuckers like Kool Moe Dee and all the motherfuckers who had a message in their music.
Get the fuck
their music had culture to it and everything.
Yep.
That shit gone.
Gone.
Now it ain't nothing but sucker shit with niggas motherfucking.
Hey.
Right.
This is no disrespect to Drake. Drake is a talented guy.
Fuck that. If he don't write his own lyrics.
Let me just say.
Do he write his own lyrics?
I don't know the nigga. I don't know.
Yeah, I can't say.
If he don't write his lyrics, he is basically a motherfucker put out there.
Oh, listen.
Created.
Right. But I'm going to say this. The motherfucker just tied Michael Jackson for being number one on the chart for consecutive weeks.
It's not
even a fair comparison, but the stat is there.
Is there.
It doesn't matter.
Because of where we are today. Mm. Like what you just explained about what's hot and what's real today. Do you understand what it took to make those albums Michael and Quincy put together?
Mm-hmm. But do you understand what the media machine is now?
Oh, yeah.
The media machine now.
Less of what it takes now?
Right.
Mm-hmm. That's what I'm saying. Well, you're talking about a whole band versus this chip.
The media machine
right.
has black people mad at me for talking about Barack Obama. When here's a man who went to office for 8 years and refused to tell you what you need to know and say what needs to be said.
But they mad
and
at
black
you.
People still make excuses for mm-hmm. him.
They mad at you. They mad at Tavis Smiley. They mad at, Cornel West.
Cornel West.
They mad at a lot of people who call Barack out early, who say, hey, what the fuck you gonna do about poor people? Now, at the end of his 8-year run, you're seeing the stats. America, in terms of the system, in terms of the dominant culture, is doing great. Oh, he cut $1 trillion off of the deficit. But wait a minute, how does any of that shit trickle back down to your people? The first black president, and you didn't do shit for yours unless they're in the dominant culture?
Let me say something about that Drake shit because we lost it. Motherfucker might say I'm hating on Drake. I'm not hating on Drake, but this is one thing I know. If he was saying something,
they would shut him down.
They would shut him down.
Yeah.
That boy on the BET Awards,
yeah.
He said something.
Well, that's why you're
it
J. Cole.
It became a problem.
Aren't as popular, J. Cole. That's why he's not as popular.
Tell the truth. Well,
anybody
shut
who's
down.
Saying something.
I say keep telling the truth. Yeah. Keep this, cause,
right. That's, fuck that's, all of that. That's my point. It's like it don't matter what records. Somebody said the media is the government. They write.
You motherfucking right.
It don't
right.
matter what records you break nowadays.
Right.
It's all bullshit.
Right.
Right.
You motherfucking right. Remember I told you.
If you ain't standing on something. You
falling
are.
For anything,
let me tell you
man.
Something. If you're not on my side,
you're against me.
You're against me.
Yeah. That's yeah. Hey, you said it the last time we talked. When somebody just said the media is the government. Let me show you this. Orlando happens. The next day on Facebook, we got gun control. Clips and videos of actors, Jamie Foxx, all types of actors talking about gun control.
You got Senate sit-ins,
all types of shit happening the day after. You trying to tell me these actors aren't part of the CIA? Listen, come on. Ronald Reagan was an actor first.
Arnold Schwarzenegger,
actor. These motherfuckers get enrolled.
Jesse Ventura.
Actor,
you know
wrestler.
All I could do is talk about the ones I was up under. Mm. I was up under Jamie Foxx. I was there when he was talking about Barack. Look, we got to get this man in office. And I wanted to say to him so bad, why are you so behind this man like that? Do you know him?
But again,
then
behind.
It all came to me. Mm-hmm. Oh, y'all gay.
That's what you thought?
I said this before. I saw the nigga walking with him in the garden.
No, I do remember this. Though.
Before I saw them niggas walking in the garden together, I said, you gay. Y'all some booty busting motherfucker.
Oh, point yeah, there we go.
I'm just saying. I watch when niggas talk. Look, when you talk passionately about another nigga, that really make me go, where you know this nigga from?
Oh.
You know what I'm saying? That's just the cold way
what
I'm
from. What if you talking passionately about Bruce Lee?
What do you mean talking passionately about Bruce Lee?
He goes, darn.
Well, I'm saying like
Bruce
like
Lee
dude.
Created Jeet Kune Do.
Like, in other words, there's
If somebody said Bruce Lee created Jeet Kune Do, I don't know nothing about that.
But no, I'm just saying, if they talking passionately, that don't mean you and Bruce Lee want to fuck each other.
I was like, what?
No, it ain't like that. It's like when a motherfucker is speaking on a man like, oh, because this is what I heard him say. We got to get this man in office. It just made me say, why the fuck did he say that? Why the fuck we got to get him in office?
He this clapped is, like that.
Man, you know,
was there a clap?
That nigga,
was there a,
no,
a patty cake?
We look, got to back when motherfuckers used to sit in, motherfuckers used to sit in on Jamie Foxx show. Because I never went up there on Fridays.
Right.
I went up there one time when they invited me. That's when they wanted to go in on Howard Stern.
Right.
But
that was crazy.
I never really go up there on Fridays because that's Jamie's show.
Right.
And I can't take over that man's show.
Right.
You know, when he's in there, he's the alpha.
Right.
And all them motherfuckers be up under him. So I'm like, okay, that's cool. I don't want to invade his space on that shit. Because I might talk too much without knowing.
Right.
But when a man is speaking on another man passionately, that don't make you stop and see what the fuck is going on? Maybe it's just me.
Yeah, I need more context.
If Freeze Love was saying,
here we go.
Man, Zoe, we got to motherfucking do this for Zoe. We got to get Zoe on point. Then I'll be like, right. What the fuck is you talking about?
Right.
My mind naturally be like, where you coming from? What's your angle?
Listen, we have to get Zoe's book sold. The one about relationships.
But hell, I don't think that's bad.
No.
Over and over and over and over again, that's bad.
Man, no, Jamie Foxx was
going
to them rallies.
The man
Jamie Foxx was going to them rallies. He was a side bitch at the rallies. I'm telling you, them niggas used to hook up.
Hey, put out that cigarette. You know Barack does not like cigarettes.
Man, he used to be there with that foxhole shit.
What is going
on? The foxhole is at the rally. I think it was in Denver one day. And we was all, they was like, Jamie out there in Denver. I'm like, niggas
shit. Ah!
Them niggas on some shit.
What the fuck?
Look, maybe it's the third eye shit I get. I read niggas.
But you did peep it early.
I read niggas.
You did peep
when it. You open your mouth, I'm watching you talk. I'm telling you.
On the gay agenda and all of that, you peeped that early.
Man, I was up amongst men who recently wiped off Dookie.
Gah!
I know them motherfuckers, man. When I'm around them, that don't mean I hate you, but you ain't fooling me, nigga. When you open your mouth, I look at your whole squad, nigga. If I'm around a nigga, who is this nigga with? If
hey,
there's
wait
one
minute.
Moist nigga in the group,
if it's two niggas smelling like one cologne.
Nigga, I'm watching you, nigga.
Yeah.
And it ain't because I'm trying to be nosy. It's just I need to establish mentally where the fuck you coming from.
Two niggas smelling like one cologne.
Man, them niggas. I mean, used to be up
y'all
there.
Y'all niggas sharing a scent.
Them lisp having ass niggas, all that shit. I used to watch them niggas. I'm like, do they know all the real niggas know y'all some punk motherfuckers? Y'all think y'all fooling motherfuckers, nigga?
No, I'm not.
You can't fool no motherfucker.
Who was that?
No.
It was James Brown. No, I'm not.
Oh, that was James.
Hey, man, when you talk, man, you show people shit.
No,
that's open, real. You open windows that you might not realize you open.
That's real.
God damn it. When I'm around your motherfucking ass, I watch niggas. And I ain't just talking about niggas like Jamie that's as obvious. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about in this town. I done seen some motherfucking hardcore-ass niggas who prefer dick.
Wow.
Not no punk motherfuckers who act like bitches. I'm talking about these niggas. I'm like, oh, this nigga get out like that. It's just like when old boy in that movie Gladiator, he was like, what do you want, girl, boy? You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying. I'm telling you, man. Girl. Just the other day, I saw four transvestites mop a cat, beat his ass.
Really?
And you know what? I have to admit, when they was whooping his ass.
And well, there's still
he glanced at me like, brother, help. And I looked away. I'm like, nigga, you caught it, man. I'm sorry, homie. I'm not helping you, nigga.
They are still men. This, they
I live in a
I'm not taking the L
out here.
It's too many.
The cokeheads are more respectable.
Moving, man.
Oh shit.
The cokehead niggas. At least them real niggas. They just on coke. Wow. But I'm talking about out here, man.
And
come
I
on,
away.
Gangsta ass niggas be fucking each other.
Wow.
And you be knowing that, it, but you won't say shit because this drama come with it.
No, I'm not.
I'm talking about real.
Hey, nigga, how
real,
come you keep going up into motherfucking Loose Booty's house? OG Loose Booty. Why they gave him that name?
I'm talking about gang. I'm talking about gang leading motherfuckers,
right.
All that shit.
Niggas that have a name like that. You be like,
fucking niggas? Damn.
And
you know who give it away a lot of times? Like I always say, man, them bitches gonna tell on you, man. Anything y'all do in front of them bitches.
Anything you do
that don't
in front
confirm
of a woman
shit.
No.
That helped you build whatever you got, if you ever cross her, she's going to open up the files on you.
Well, they shut Tim Duncan's wife up.
Somebody gave her some bread, right?
They gave her some bread to shut the fuck up. But me and my niggas knew that nigga was a sissy back at the All-Star game in Cleveland back in the day
when he had the tongue ring.
The tongue ball. Like, niggas don't do that. Fuck you doing with that, nigga.
Right.
Big, tall, sis-ass nigga.
Oh, gosh.
Hey, this is real talk.
I know he was on the phone with Jason Collins. If you out me, listen, I'm going to have you killed.
Oh, as he was clicking his motherfucking
tongue ball.
Right.
Ew.
You little
take that motherfucker that out shit. At night.
A giant with a tongue ball.
A hole in your throat. Because you want to tickle a sack.
Oh,
with a ball, nigga. Get your pussy ass out of here, nigga.
You got a hole in your throat because you want to tickle a sack.
This nigga Kool-Aid dripping.
He actually went and had that done. Pull his tongue out.
His mouth is leaking because he wanted
to laugh.
Tickle a sack.
That's why he could play so long and shit. Everybody who had, all men who done had a dick in their ass. Them motherfuckers got to jump to them naturally.
Mm. They're more aerodynamic.
Right.
No, I'm not.
No, I'm not. Jeans.
Right.
Goddamn jeans. Anyway.
But, I done fucking act like I'm mad at them niggas. I ain't mad at them niggas. I'm just letting you know. You niggas ain't fooling me, nigga. Stupid. I know who you are.
Sack wrestling. These niggas.
Damn.
No, I'm not. That's the stupidest shit I've ever heard.
You might say y'all drunk. I ain't drunk, shit. I ain't had nothing to drink. I can't
you
drink.
You ain't drunk.
No, I'm not.
Anyway, all right, so we going.
Right. It is after 10. What is it?
We finna get ready to get the fuck up out of here, man. Mm. Listen, Miami, I'm fucking with y'all Thursday night, but that show sold out. It's a special show. They got some Black Weekend going on down there in Miami, and Thursday night I'm doing this show, but... Just come on down to West Palm Beach. West Palm Beach Improv.
Excellent.
Y'all come fuck with me this weekend, man. Hey, Nashville, y'all did y'all thing. God damn it. We had to add 2 shows.
And
all the Murfreesboro niggas I was talking to outside the show.
Oh, shit.
Some fat nigga, his girl left him because she ain't like the show, and he was laughing.
Oh.
That nigga was standing out there with me. Man, that bitch gone. Fuck that bitch.
That's
a barber.
Did you take photos?
Damn, I had his business card and forgot to bring it. I was going to shout him out because he stayed. He was like, fuck that bitch. She gone.
Wow. Oh, my God. That's too funny.
So, anyway, West Palm Beach, Friday, Saturday, Sunday is the fuck on. Mm. Get your tickets. Fuck with me. You know I got it. Anybody got something to plug?
Always my t-shirts. Go to my little website. I am Zoe Williams. We got 2 designs on there. Purchase your t-shirts. Just click the shop button. I'll send it out. Of course, my book, The Relationship Dismount, How to Stick the Landing When Exiting a Toxic Relationship. That's also available on my website. I am Zoe Williams. And then also, I got this Indiegogo campaign that we're trying to raise money so I could produce the next book, the follow-up to the Relationship Dismount. So
it's the Foxhole Dismount.
Yeah, man, just get up at me, man.
Dismount.
It's on Indiegogo, the Holographic Relationship. That's my new Indiegogo campaign. Go there and support the movement. That's what we're doing.
There you go.
Download the Freeze Love app. There you go. It's free.
Mm-hmm.
Freeze Love app.
FreezLuv.
Hey, man, look, all them guys at the Foxhole, don't think I don't like y'all, but it was very hard being in there knowing that it was backdoor dookie shit going on in them doors that I never went in that back. I never went to the back. You know, the back part.
Stop, I can't with you.
Where they had offices, I was always scared to go back there. One day it was a silent moment, and I heard something go, woo, woo, woo. I was like, oh, shit, there's a nigga back there.
God.
No, I'm not.
No.
You got the bolo
shirt. Corey, you
ready?
Going in the back offices at Foxhole?
Oh, here
no,
we go.
I'm not.
And all I'm saying, man, it was like about 2 minutes before Jamie came out there and got on his show. I heard some nigga go, ah!
And then you said, who's back there? Corey, you back there?
Shut up, D. We ain't gonna talk about what your ass probably done did.
When?
You, goddammit. You fuck with moist niggas.
Whatever. That's all guys like you have to say about it. That's helps you feel good.
Go get your weenie.
Talking about that guys being gay. That's what guys do when they, oh, he's gay.
Hey,
he's
D,
gay.
You with a weenie.
No, but I did get a phone call today from a huge crush of mine, all-time crush of mine, so that made my day today.
Is he famous?
Sort of.
D ain't going to say
no, I'm not going to say, but thank you for calling.
What, Curtis Blow?
No, I'm not.
Yeah. Oh, God. Sort
of. No. He's the best brake mechanic in Van Nuys.
Who called you, D? I know it's an old school famous.
It is, but it's not. You would never know. I'm not going to put him on blast.
Richard Roundtree called your phone, didn't
he? No, please. Oh, no. But anyway, he has a girlfriend. He just called to say, you know, hello, what's up? And
yeah, right. Who
I swear on everything. And that he appreciated the book and that he loved the book. I'm not playing. No. You we already know. We know each other like that already. I already know, but he has a girlfriend. But he just
it was
old
boy off New Jack City.
There's no.
Hello, baby. We want some cake too.
Oh, he's passed.
Oh, he's passed.
Yes, Nick at Ashford.
Ashford and Simpson.
Yeah, Nick. He passed.
My
me.
Man, I didn't know.
Anyway.
I forgot, rather. I
anyway,
think you told me that.
Yeah.
Who was it? Was it a cast member off Ricochet of New Jack City?
No, none,
Tolo,
none,
we
no.
Got the power.
I said a crush of mine.
Wow,
no,
dang.
Like I got a crush on them. Are you kidding me? No, why would it be him? Oh God,
Jason Priestley.
Who's
no,
that?
Who's that? What the white boy on 90210?
Yeah, that was just
Howard Hewitt.
Oh no,
Howard Hewitt.
That's a good. No, I'm not gonna say this girl might not be.
It was the son off 227.
No, he was just reaching out. It was really. Oh God, no. No, he's actually
the
my
first
age.
Lionel Jefferson. Who was it?
I am not gonna say because
Billy
she might,
Ocean.
She might get upset, and he just called to say that he liked the book. That's
all. Reviewed Mexico.
Somebody said it was Bobby Brown.
No, God, no. No, it's somebody that I've had a crush
it's
on.
It's Marquee.
Corey, I just said it's somebody that I've had an all-time crush on.
So you said, what you said, something wrong with Biz Marquee?
What do you mean? I've never had a crush on him.
Flavor.
No, come on. You would really think I'd have a crush on him?
Picking boogers.
Anyway, it's not like he said anything out the way. He just wanted to tell me that he liked my book, but I was just so excited that I like.
Well, who was the nigga? We trying to figure out who was it.
No, he
David Hasselhoff.
Right.
No.
Howard Hewitt.
Coolio.
It's time to say goodbye for now.
He was not. He was not white, and he was not black.
Somebody said Bob Saget.
No, it was not Marcellus.
The lead singer of Menudo.
No, it was not Marcellus. He's happily married with a child. And his child is so cute. Marcellus' kid is so cute.
Flavor Flav.
She said he's not black.
He's not black and he's not white.
He's not black or he's not white. Oh.
I know who it was.
Christopher Williams.
Shabadoo.
No, God. That is the homie, though, but no, that's not him, and I never had a crush on him either. But anyway, good luck. You'll never figure
so
it out.
White.
But he just made my day.
The
no,
dude with
I just
the pink
said
lips
not,
in the battle
I
on
said
breaking.
He's not white and he's not black.
That one time.
So
that
he's Latin.
In the
I'm not saying anything. I just gave you guys enough hint.
She
but
gave
anyway.
Us a hint.
Yeah. Latin. And he's hot for his age. I'm just saying, but he didn't call to reach
is
out
he
to
old
me.
Old
like that.
Julio Iglesias.
It's the nigga off them Dos Equis commercials.
You know what, Chris, back there laughing. You laughing too loud, homie. Not really. Anyway.
I don't know. It's called
Somebody
Darlene.
Said Billy Blanks.
Oh, shit.
Billy Blanks.
Sammy Sosa.
He's not black and he's not one. White.
Pootie Tang called you.
No, I'm not going to give it out.
Don't tell us.
Because he has a girl, and I don't think she'd be. He just wanted to say that he really liked the book.
Does his girl watch the show?
I don't know, but I'm just saying, you never know if it could get
if
around
she
to
ain't
somebody.
Telling the name that nigga put his beard in.
No, he did not. Swear to God on everything I love.
Well, who was the nigga?
I'm not going to say. I'm just saying. He was not. She
you ain't
going to
fuck with him anyway.
Rollo from Sanford and Son.
You never know if she leaves him.
Juan Valdez.
They're not married.
Somebody said Cheech and Chong.
Get out, Darlene.
They're not married together.
Ty-Mac from The Last Dragon.
Maury Povich.
No, although he looks really good still for his
Willie
age.
Nelson.
Eddie Arcanian off The Last Dragon.
What? No.
She's anyway, be that dead just, tired if
I
she
just
don't
said
fuck
that
me.
Made my day that I got a phone call. For goodness all right. sake. All right, exactly.
We're going to wrap the shit up.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
All right, so I want to say to all
El
of
El Chapo. That's a good one.
El Chapo.
Listen, I just need a place to stay for a couple of nights.
Oh, God.
Urkel, anyway, live back. With my own. Motherfuckers got all kind of show nuff.
Oh, Lord.
Yes. No, I'm not.
George Lopez. No, no but I actually flirt. I like George Lopez. I love George Lopez. But no, it was not him.
I got to hear that change, bro.
Kid Frost.
Richard Dawson.
No, did he pass? Richard, he's really Kid Frost, you know, he's passed. Really sick. No, no, I was asking.
He's really sick, is he?
You never knew that?
I didn't hear that. I
somebody said
not,
Fabio.
Man. Much love.
Very
to
sick.
Nigga.
I know. Yeah, he's very sick.
Pray for that, brother. I love Kid Frost.
Yeah, he is. He's the homie, OG. Too. Like, he's like
Tyra Banks.
Very funny. I take her over all them guys you said, though. God.
Darlene,
I'm going to figure it out.
Yeah, right. I can't stand that.
You ain't never had a pussy in your mouth.
Never. Never in my life.
I'm going to figure it out. Crazy Legs.
No.
Crazy Legs. From New York.
Mr. Wave from Breaking.
I'm not.
Beach Street.
God, why are you guys still on? I thought you said you were going to move on. Anyway.
MC Search.
Oh, I just said he wasn't white. Oh, God.
Hey, he's Jewish.
Up? But that's hella white.
Who's the lead rapper of Cypress Hill? I'm losing.
Be Real? No.
Sin Dog.
Although Be Real is one of my crushes, though, but that was not him.
Victor Maitland from Beverly
Thank
Hills
God,
Cop.
I'm a Mexican.
Who the hell is that?
The bad guy. Victor Maitland?
Don't know who
Beverly
he is.
Beverly Hills Cop?
Don't know who he is.
Shut up!
No, now if Michael Pena hollered at me, though, I think he's adorable.
Who's Michael Pena?
Michael Pena? Don't oh, my God.
Know who that is.
Actor? Just about in everything? Look up Michael Pena. Latin
he can do
actor.
Better than you.
Somebody said Fat Joe.
Michael Pena?
Yeah.
Of course Vin he could, Diesel. But that's why I said if he reaches out to me, I'd
was
like
in,
to get...
Was he in Breaking Bad?
Was he in Breaking Bad? I don't know. He was in a crap load of movies, but I like him. He's so cute.
Oh, Gary Busey.
Gary Busey?
Oh, God.
Get over here with that ass.
Although when we did Survive in the Game, we were out in the... We were.
I don't want to hear that shit. Hey, look here. No, fuck with that.
We were on set with him for 3 months.
Gary Busey?
Yeah. Doing Survive in the Game.
Did he speak to you?
Well, Gary Busey's white.
Oh, yes, he's white.
But did he speak to you on set?
What do you mean? We
Gary
were there.
Busey.
For, yeah, of course.
He wasn't acting funny with you?
What do you mean funny as in what way? Disrespectful? No, I was there with my ex. No, of course not.
Oh, Jackie yeah, but he was acting cool?
Of course he was very cool.
What did he say to you?
What did he say to me? We intermingled, we interacted and intermingled every day.
Really?
Yeah.
So he's a cool guy?
Very cool.
Gary Busey cool.
Gary Busey, very cool guy.
Quaaludes, darn.
And what's homeboy's name from the, remember that, The Rock? What was that, that show, The Rock? Brother that was married to homegirl that was on the soap opera.
Dutton.
Charles Dunn. He was real cool too. He was on there.
Charles.
He was like, hey, D, how you doing?
He was skipping around. You know, tell you what, Joey.
Stop.
So you how know, Eleanor.
How you and Ice doing?
Right.
That underhand and flirting shit nigga right. be doing. So no. you and your guy, y'all good, right? That's yeah. good.
Well, let me know if you ever need a refrigerator move.
Skipping and shit. You know, darling, shit.
No, but we were the only family out
I just
there,
saw Ice over there. He was talking to somebody.
Oh, he's talking to a girl? No. Anyway, very
side
cool.
Side salt.
Very right. cool people.
Side salt.
That's a good one.
That's a good one. Side salt. Uh-huh. Side salt ass nigga.
Side salt.
Right. Anyway, but that made my day,
if,
just saying
if
that.
You happy
I felt
with
good.
I'm happy for
y'all. I'm glad you guys are happy.
That's a good one, yeah. You know? But if anything,
but if you ever need anybody to talk to, you know, can things always, get a little rocky.
Can always rely on me.
Side salt.
Right. Like, side can salt. Always rely on me.
You want that salt like this.
Well, let's just sprinkle a little salt and change the light.
See, you all right, boy, you know you be killing them. That's what niggas be doing.
Well, that actually happened from
a girl. That's you? That's you? Yeah, boy. Yeah. I like that one.
Somebody got busted doing
side
salt.
You're doing real good, ain't you?
Somebody got busted doing side salt from my aunt. He actually rolled up right as the side salt was being thrown.
Oh.
And I can say this one because it was witnesses that had that actually saw it happen in the front of the House of Blues.
That nigga Tank tried to side salt me.
Oh, Tank's the homie. You know, that's my son used to go paintballing with him. They're on the same team.
I was with my wife. That nigga said some slick shit. I was like, homie, this is my wife. She ain't listen to that.
He side salted? Don't let him sing.
That
fool. Woo-wee. He's so good.
Get shit out of here, nigga.
Whatever. He's so good. Hi, Tank. He's sweet. That's the homie.
Say more.
What, nigga?
Say more. Shit, defend your wife.
We was at this little celebrity right? game.
Exactly.
And he saw me with my wife. I forgot what he said. Some little slick shit like about weight or something like that. You know, we don't play like that.
He snack kinged you?
Yeah, some shit like that.
He snack kinged you. You?
I guess he was looking for a laugh, and we both was looking at that nigga like, nigga, get your better go sing, nigga.
He side snacked you.
Don't know you.
What did he say? You don't remember what he said?
Some little slick shit. I forgot exactly what he said, but it's that shit. You know how when you speak to a nigga all the time, y'all cool.
Right.
But you don't play with that nigga like that.
Oh, God.
What up, homie? Hey, I didn't bring your donuts today.
Some shit like that. Say some shit like that.
Oh, really? Well, go get them then, motherfucker.
He's so sweet.
I want a dozen
so
right now.
That's tell me your recipe, and I should tell you mine.
I don't see that.
Niggas be nice to you, D, because they want some ass. But niggas try niggas.
No, he's never been disrespectful,
yeah,
though.
Throw a hat in the ring. See right. Who can come put it on.
Oh, right. I can't. I yeah, love man. It. I wish it was in.
All them R&B niggas. R&B niggas do not know how to act around women. Them niggas always say some old suave ass shit.
And they always got on some old tight ass shirt, too.
He snicker barge you.
Right.
Although Brian McKnight, he kind of did that. He had just gotten out of his divorce, and I ran into him at backstage at a concert, and
he
could see him.
And I was
that.
Like, God, too bad I'm not, because I love his singing, but I'm not into him. But he did a little side salt kind of thing, like doing it, like, oh, how you doing? How you been? You know,
oh, you love
he,
my singing.
And then
you
somebody else
in
asked him, I just got divorced. Line. It's kind of sad and everything. I was like, why do we know that? Yeah, he had just gotten divorced.
So he told you he was divorced?
No, not me. It was a little crowd, but we were there. I walked right up.
So how did he side salt you?
No, but that's kind of like a side salt, throwing it out there. Like, instead of making himself look like a hoe or anything, he just kind of threw that out there to everybody. Like,
he let
no,
him know he was getting divorced.
You know.
Robin Knight did some hoe-ass shit to me one day, too. We did this little TV show for him, and that nigga never gave me my money.
No.
And then
that's
the nigga tried
cool.
to talk to me one day on the airplane. Because, you know, I ain't tripping on this shit.
Are you sure he was handling it? Nobody else handled it for him?
What? No, that's that bitch. That man, get the fuck out of here. I know
exactly.
What the fuck happened to me.
Just like Lisa Ray did that shit to me.
Oh,
you know me some bread like
did.
A motherfucker. Some shit in New
York.
Then
the nigga see me. He realized I ain't said shit to him because we done seen each other a few times. But I guess on the plane, he couldn't help it. He was like, what's up, man? I was like,
my money, nigga.
Oh.
Bread.
Stop.
Chips and dip. Nigga.
You remember when he was doing the Brian McKnight show?
Yeah.
I take that shit. Them niggas never gave me my check, dog.
Oh,
wow.
You didn't get per diem either. They're concerned, didn't they?
Did you get access?
I already, look, but I used to try to like the nigga. I used to try
yeah,
to like
cool.
him.
I like him.
He
he's
ain't
nice.
Cool. One
I
day
think
we
he's
was
a
hooping.
Nice guy.
One day we was hooping.
They funny style on the hoop.
And I'm this like, nigga didn't get his call, and he act like he was gonna leave. And them niggas was like, "Don't go, Brian. Come on."
Stop.
He can play a little bit though.
Yeah.
I was dying laughing. I was like,
got hit in the
"He
right
gave that nigga the call because
he can play a little bit. His sons can play too."
Well, I don't know nothing about his sons. We used to hoop
bit.
Up there at Balboa. And he had the little average actor game. Nigga, that motherfucker was acting like he raw, nigga. Fuck that shit.
Stop. Cut it out.
I'm just keeping it 100.
Cut it out.
I ain't hating, but I ain't never get my cheese, Brian, if you ever.
That's not cool.
It wasn't no
that's
real
that,
money either.
That's
it wasn't
not
nothing
nice.
But a G. Y'all told me y'all was going to give me a G.
Mm.
I never got the G. So, motherfucker,
His P.O. boxes.
What's one of his songs? You like him? D, what is
no,
his
I
song?
Like another person. I don't listen to his songs a lot. I don't. I don't listen to his songs.
What songs you listen to?
Y'all know
Jamie. I like Jamie's little songs.
Jamie's smart. He makes
Jamie
catchy
kill
to him.
The game. Jamie can sing.
Blame it on the alcohol. Woo! Is it just in fact? Yeah, he knows.
I've
he
seen
doing.
Him, and I've seen him. and I've seen him try to sing like someone else's, do a cover.
Hey, yeah,
kill
one
it.
Last cry.
Kill it. Kill
hey,
it.
Nigga.
One last cry. That's
hey, it. You need to fuck Porters until you get my money, y'all. Stealing motherfuckers.
Here we go.
One last crime.
One last crime.
Right. Okay.
No, I like every one time I run him. He's a nice crime. Guy, though. That was funny.
All
right,
fuck
anyway, all right, all right, all right, all right.
We thank y'all for watching the 5150 show.
5150.
After having good brother David Banner, I'm not afraid to have guests anymore. I was afraid to have guests because of the Sissy Mayor. I think about that nigga sitting amongst me. And it kind of make me sizzle inside because he was a puss-ass nigga. And I'm like, damn, dog, I sat up with this nigga, man. Puss-ass nigga. I just want to catch that jaw. I don't want it to keep going. I just want to steal on him and whatever he do to retaliate. All right, fuck it, it's over.
I wait, stop. I just what the hell is
he
that?
I have a gun, Clark, and I will not allow you to put your hands on me.
I know.
He ain't gonna whoop me. The nigga ain't gonna whoop me. So what? He might try to swing back because everybody looking.
No. I have a registered firearm, and I will use it on you.
So now we have guests now, so we can check in.
This guy.
Yeah, but it's got to be good guests, D. It can't be the people who you bring and shit.
Excuse me. So you just made a blanket statement that you just said, got to be good guests, not none of the people you bring.
I'm working on a few people, man.
Bring motherfuckers who ain't got no type of stardom and shit.
Excuse me? Really? Name a couple people you brought, huh? I don't have to go there.
I don't bring motherfuckers with me because I don't give
is
a fuck.
Is that right?
I don't bring people.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Oh, I had Sam
I
up here.
My friend, Cisco. Yo, they lit
who is Cisco?
See? Is if you don't get this European Mexican motherfucker out of here.
Oh, that's my man.
Let's go to homie.
Yeah.
Like
he cool.
Yeah.
Anytime cool. I've mentioned people that I want to bring, either you've got some kind of either problem with them.
Who you said you're going to bring?
I'm not going to say it on air. I'm going to tell you when we finish.
Say the name. Fuck him. Say
it. You got to be vetted out before he come up here.
But I'm saying, like, who I got a problem with?
I'm not going to say it. It's going to start something, but I'm going to tell you once the show goes off.
Who would it start something with?
If you were to say something, because you just said I'd bring people that, and I'm going to tell
but
you
I,
why
I was
told me.
Joking with you right there, but I can't imagine who you would say I would
all
have
right,
a problem with.
Well, I will
with.
Tell you later, because I don't want to say it on air.
What, is it a pussy motherfucker?
No, not at all. Like, I wasn't even too sure why you said something about him, but anyway.
Who is the nigga?
I'm not going to start something, Corey.
You already started something. You just ain't finishing it.
No, I'm not going to put it out there for the public.
Scat Rad.
What'd you say?
Scat Rad. That's the Chicago shit for being afraid. Scat Rad.
Scat Rad.
Scat Rad. Get your Scat Rad out of here, nigga. Oh, Scat Rad.
I don't want to start nothing with somebody that there's nothing, you know, really there. I don't want to say it because he's a known person.
Wrong.
We know.
I want you to say it.
No, you don't. No, you don't.
No, I'm not.
Why would not?
No, I'm not. Because you didn't mean it like that, or else we would have said, no, you didn't. I know what happened. I'm going to tell you when the show goes off.
You know what happened with what?
There you go. I'm not going to think. God dang
now,
it.
Now she going to ask. She just want to talk to me after the show. That's all.
Oh, God. Oh, yes.
Nobody to talk to. D be perpetrating this shit. D just like old girl. These legs are fake. When she leave the place, goddammit, and get home, she take the motherfuckers off like, oh, girl, I'm going to get you sucker.
I got prosthetic legs.
Goddammit. Sometimes they need to be rebooted, so she had Chris Breve on them. On the Godzilla side of the game.
Nice legs. Caramelized legs. There's your time.
Caramelized legs, nigga.
Oh.
Chris used to beatbox, but his hand looked like an old boy at the beginning of the show. Pierre. That nigga hand.
Fingers flying
oh
all
my
over.
That's
fucked up. Acid spit.
No, I'm not.
No, I'm not.
So all my niggas who be low-key telling me they tried the hot water on the dick shit, man, ain't nothing to be ashamed of. That shit was fire, wasn't it?
Oh, God. There
niggas
you
put
guys
warm
go.
Water on your dick while you're nothing when you jag off. That shit is fucking amazing.
Oh, yeah, there we go.
Yeah. Shit is fucking amazing. Anyway, all right, bust that nut alone. If you got somebody with you, don't spend the night if you don't know her.
No, I'm not.
My name is Corey Holcomb, and we thank you for
That's
participating
right.
in this coonery.
Mm-hmm. You know what? Stop.
Foolery, I mean. We ain't cooning. Fuck the nigga.